Hello, I'm Will Wheaton, and you're watching TableTop on CBS.
Jeez.
That's Toby Turner.
Hello, and welcome to Drycast, Gamecast, Try Not to Diecast, where we'll be playing Betrayal on the House on the Hill. At the House on the Hill.
Okay, yeah. So the joke here is that I don't ever play games, and I ruin games. And I don't know how to play games, and I usually just watch, but tonight I'm going to put forth genuine effort.
He's going to participate. Now, everyone else has slept through their character, so let's start with you, Micah.
Okay.
Introduce you and your character.
While David picks.
We'll get to David.
Okay, I am playing Jenny LeClerc. I think that's her name. She is 21 years old, 5'7", weighs 142 pounds. Her hobbies are reading and soccer, and her birthday is March 4th.
Thank you, Micah.
So that's
Greg.
That pentagon, I almost said octagon, tells you all
one,
that.
One, two, three, four, five mm-hmm. sides, so pentagon.
Thank you, Greg.
Yes. Yes, I figured
five
out.
Five sides.
That's a bold move, Cotton. I hope it plays out.
Thank you. Was that a game thing?
That was a movie reference, okay. David.
There are things.
Okay,
they are moving pictures.
So moving on.
Moving on.
So I'm Greg.
That's Greg.
Greg. Hello, Greg.
Greg.
I am Madame Zostra?
Close enough.
Right, okay. I'm 37 years old. I'm 5 foot nothing, 150 pounds, and my hobbies are astrology, cooking, and baseball. My birthday is December 10th.
Hello, I'm Terrence Reginald Coxworth Esquire III, and I'll be playing Darren Flash Williams. He's real fucking fast.
Super slow.
He's Will Wheaton too, actually.
I'm Will Wheaton too, actually. he is 20 years old. 5'11", 188 pounds. Hobbies include track, music, and Shakespearean literature. P.S. That's Henry. Birthday is June the 6th.
Hi, I'm Kevin Smith. We're actually filming Clerks 3 right now. This is Silent Bob. You got a haircut. Actually, my name is Cray J. But I'm playing Professor Longfellow. He's just a good old-fashioned guy. He likes to mingle. His hobbies are Gaelic music, drama, fine wine, children. His weight is 153 pounds. His height is 5'11". He's 57 years old, but he's a spry 57. His birthday is July 27th.
Does it really say children?
It doesn't actually say children. Although this would explain why he's in a haunted house with two children, two women, and a 20-year-old boy. Anyway. And finally, we get to David, a.k.a. Will Wheaton, a.k.a. the Denim Deacon, a.k.a. whatever. You have the choice of one of the two children in this game.
There are four children.
Well,
it's
one of the
options.
No, true.
Okay, let me just say that I know absolutely nothing.
Same.
Like, my board game knowledge is limited to Candyland. It's like, actually, it's even more limited because I honestly don't remember how to play Candyland.
How do you not remember the game?
You spin the dial and you move on?
No,
anyway.
there's no dial.
They're the cards.
Oh, it was the cards.
It's
the
cards.
Dial was on,
you literally just get colors.
Apparently,
colors
shoots and ladders.
You move, like, one, two, maybe
three. The joke
three
here is that I
purple
no, not
bad at the game.
Green
each of these
squares
cards
bad
is a character. Each one has two sides, so there's technically four choices. Make your choice.
Okay.
And introduce you.
Pick wisely.
They're all young children. Are you going to be a little boy or a little girl?
Keep in mind that you are sitting next to Professor Longfellow.
Yeah, yes.
Do it.
Sorry, I know I'm fiddling, but...
No, fiddle.
You're not allowed to fiddle.
See his butt again.
That actually is relevant. If you see...
Huh?
If you would be willing to pay for pictures... of any pictures of me, just send him
an email.
Including pictures of his butt.
But not well. But it'd be
not
clothed.
Limited to.
It'd be clothed. I have to say that you won't be getting anything that you wouldn't already see in public. So, anyway,
clothes are optional.
This is a true thing.
If you want pictures of me, you don't have to pay for them. You can just email me at bigboys. Now this is crucial. Dot jellylover at yahoo.com.
That's your real email?
No.
Oh, good.
Don't send things there.
Don't send things there.
Well, David@ws is a real email address, and I wasn't joking about the pictures, but...
Wumo.com.
Pictures from David are real.
Wumo.com.
Can I get a picture from David?
Yeah, but it would just be of me, and you have to pay a lot.
I'll frame it, put it in my bathroom so I can stare at you.
It'd be more economical for you to just take a picture of me now.
But I want to buy a picture of you.
All right.
Why would you buy a picture? I can just take a picture
So I can choose from Brandon, whose hobbies are computers, camping, and hockey.
I could put this up.
He's really tiny.
Snap story right now.
I think I might actually do Brandon, because Missy...
You don't want to play Missy?
No, I'm not.
Doesn't she look creepy?
She's a little girl with a teddy bear.
She looks terrifying. She's creepy.
What's her ethnicity?
White. Oh, there's a second side to this.
There's both sides.
Oh.
Yeah, there's two sides.
Zoe or Peter. Okay. Peter's hobbies are bugs, so he's immediately out.
What a lame-o.
I'm just going to go with Brandon. I mean...
All right.
Cool.
Look, Brandon's tiny, and he's 12.
So Brandon is a 10.
What do I do with this now?
You give that to me.
Well, it's non-playable. I will put it to the side.
Thank you, dear.
Look, I should apologize in advance because...
Take these clips.
Well, I'm not joking when I say that I psychologically am just not...
It'll be okay. Every little thing is going to be all right.
No, it's not. You're going to die.
So what you're going to do with those clips is you're going to place them on the edges here, on the green, so they'll mark the green numbers. That's your starting stat. Like this. Like he has done here.
They just slide on, yeah.
So is the purpose of this to more visually mark them?
Yes.
They clip onto the sides.
Your stats will change throughout the game as it progresses.
So, because, like, you might get driven insane.
Yeah.
And then you die.
Oh, by the way, try not to die cast. Actually true. If you die in the game, I shoot you. That includes myself.
Wow.
After recent events, I would like to clarify that he's not actually going to shoot you.
Can he actually shoot us, though, please?
Hi.
Things got really dark recently in the news.
I don't pay attention to the news, and you know that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there's another school shooting. We need to talk about that.
Yeah.
We haven't gone a single month without a mass shooting this year, so...
Yeah, that's the thing.
People are going to be...
I think it's always just going to be too soon.
Probably.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, too soon. Which one are you talking about now?
Too soon. Civil War.
Civil War too soon.
That is too soon, though. I mean, the Civil War.
Still very fresh in AJ's mind. I actually would ask if you to never mention the Civil War around him again.
Did I mention the dude homies. Who came in?
What?
The last, or yesterday, a dude came in to the gas station. A young African-American gentleman. And he was straight face. And no hesitation. He was even on the phone when I gave him the total. He said, I shouldn't have to pay for this. I like to pay in reparations. And honestly, I'm disappointed that more people haven't done that. And I told him to go up to customer service.
Is this one of your friends?
Yeah.
I told him to go up to customer service and take that up with them, because that is... their issue, but I asked that if I could come along because I was.
I wanted to record this. Please,
Terry, me and AJ were here for this. Huh. I was there for that.
I was
that.
Standing right
especially
next to him.
Especially if he was talking to the one young lady that's now at the desk that had to ask the address of the gas station today.
All right.
Yeah, no, customer service.
Does she not know that it's on the same property? Does she think that we're
away? I think the gas station has a different.
We do have a different address than the store. That is true.
She just wanted to double check because that guy came in and was like...
Okay, yeah, you're right.
He was looking for a certain...
She said something else ATM that was ridiculous
bank,
today, too.
So.
Alrighty then.
Reparations.
So,
she asked us if we had an ATM. She asked if we had an ATM and what the address was, and that's it.
If everyone would take a look at their birthday, whoever has the soonest birthday in the year goes first. My birthday is June the 6th.
December.
The soonest
like,
in the year.
From
that's D-Day.
Date,
earliest
like,
in the year?
I'm pretty sure that means whatever one is closest
to
this
now?
Current date.
Okay, well, then closest
to
the current date.
So 2 months.
2 months, December.
March. So not
was
me.
That your actual birthday?
No,
no
so close,
sorry.
Though.
28th. 28th.
Well, definitely not me, because it's May 21st.
I'm March.
I think
so
I
it's
get
not
to
me.
First.
Okay.
July.
And so I think Caitlin gets to go first.
It's going
to
be Caitlin. I mean, Greg. Greg's going first.
Greg.
Edit that out.
No. So what do I do? What's...
All right.
We don't know how to play.
I know.
Okay, don't worry.
We're going to get there. It'll be all right.
I'm impatient.
Step one. Your speed is what?
3.
You can move 3 rooms. Each one of these yellow boxes represents a door that leads to another room. So, if you were to move forward, that'd be one. If you wanted to move right, that'd be one, and you would open up a new door, or a new room. What is your choice? Oh, right. Greg is really bad at decisions. She has been given four of them.
But wait, so what exactly happened?
This is your character.
Yes.
Oh, no, this is your character. You're blue.
Yes, I'm blue.
So you can move one, one, two, one, two, one, one, two, and then up to the third floor, three.
And those are your options.
And those are your options. And if you go through one of these doors, you will draw a card, one of these little room cards here, and you will place it there.
Place it on the play. Then there will be something in that room.
That you will have to do.
I'll have to do?
Yeah, you have to do stuff.
It's cards and stuff, okay. Don't worry.
Well, I want to go upstairs.
Okay, so she's not going to open any rooms.
No rooms have been opened.
Wait, is that how that works?
Yeah,
you have to go through a new room.
Go through a new room to get one of these cards?
Yes.
Well, I want to go there then.
All right, okay. So you draw a card. Oh, let's try not to kill everything.
And?
It's the patio.
So yes. Put it down underneath you.
So that it will attach.
And you have to make a door to a door, yeah.
Yep.
Well, that's...
There you go.
Makes sense.
Now, on this, you see that there's a little swirly thing.
There's a little thing.
It's the patio.
That's an event. So you draw an event card. Read it aloud.
Out loud?
Mm-hmm.
The walls of this room are damp with blood. The blood drips from the ceiling down the walls, over the furniture, and onto your shoes. In a blink, it's gone. You must attempt a sanity roll.
Okay, don't worry about it. You're good.
Don't worry the rest?
Nope. Sanity
roll. So, sanity roll.
So, what's your sanity?
You want to say you die.
Four.
Yeah, I just that means that you'll roll sanity four roll.
Yeah.
So, what does the rest of the card say now?
You must attempt a sanity roll.
Four plus.
Four plus, you steal yourself, gain one sanity. Two to three, lose one sanity, or zero to one, if an explorer monster is in your room or an adjacent one, you must attack it, if you can. Choose the explorer with the lowest might, if possible.
Okay.
Oh, no, I dropped it!
Here.
I got it.
She got it. It's all good. Not this one. Not that one.
Go ahead and roll. You rolled a two. You lose one sanity.
No!
Those aren't real die.
So that's your knowledge. They're not real die. Yes.
Oh, yeah, they're...
There's something wrong with those.
Yes,
these dice.
You can only roll max of two per die.
Go one, two.
All right. It goes clockwise.
Because there's so many.
They're loaded.
So one, that's all that happened?
Two.
That's
one,
it?
Two.
Shit! I got it. We're good.
I knew that was going to happen.
Is this an expensive...
But I thought it was going
to
be
me.
No.
That needs
did
to
you
knock
it? Didn't you knock the wine, too?
Shush!
Yeah. I thought it was going to be me, because I break drop stuff all the time at work.
We have paper towels this time, though.
Yes.
This is true.
They just don't get sticky cards all over the place.
We didn't hit any cards, though.
That one did get a little wet, actually.
You got a little wet.
Anyway.
That's it's my turn, and I apologize.
It's not okay.
I love
Rude.
You.
Rude!
No.
I do, though.
Is this how we go this way?
Yeah, it's going to be her turn.
Clockwise?
Yes.
Those people that go counterclockwise are not okay.
What is that? What is
They're
counter?
Crazy.
I thought it was something that was specified by game.
It is specified by the game.
So see, go clockwise. I thought the counterclockwise
no,
was
you
just
go
the opposite of clockwise.
It is.
It is.
You said, what is counterclockwise? I thought that's what
it
was.
What is that? No, I was just saying, what is that? What is that?
I was being facetious, I'm sorry.
You.
Go home.
Jerk.
I am
anyway,
home. This is my house.
It's my turn, I guess.
All right.
Oh,
again? God. We're going to knock some more stuff over tonight. We're going to have a fun time.
Just table flip. win at everything for life.
I'm David's... going to move to the right.
So one to the right.
Can't do that because it's not a ground level. There it is.
Okay.
Ah! Where? Doesn't matter which way you connect it.
All
so.
Right. This is, lo and behold, the junk room.
Again?
Yeah, the junk room again. When exiting, you must attempt a might roll of 3+. If you fail, lose one speed, but continue moving.
Great.
You continue moving.
Wait, so what happens?
If I can't get out, I'm fucked.
Also, get an omen card.
Oh, yay! An omen card, guys. That's great. Hey, I recognize this one.
Hey, it's David's butt again.
Hello, David's
it's
butt.
It's not in the...
It's not in the shot, but...
Oh, well.
There it is.
Don't
What's
mind
that?
You.
Don't mind you. Spirit board. A board with letters and numbers to call the dead.
Ooh.
Again.
Before you move during your turn, you can look at the top tile of the room stack. If you use the spirit board after the haunt is revealed, the traitor can move any number of monsters one space closer to you. Great.
What?
The haunt is something you'll learn about.
We'll get there.
Say, I don't understand.
Don't worry.
It's a secret.
It is a secret.
Okay, pause. There.
Okay. So.
Resume. Game on.
Okay, so.
Game on.
Game over.
So I have an omen card.
Game off.
So that means.
That means she has to make a haunt check.
Haunt roll.
At this point in the game, it's damn near impossible for her to fail this, but if she manages to roll all blanks, we go into the haunt.
A haunt check, by the way, is you have to roll meet or beat. You have to roll the dice, six dice.
I think
we're
fine.
You have to meet or beat the number of omen cards that have been drawn thus far. If we do not beat it, the haunt begins, and then we begin the fun little story part of this game.
For now, it's just exploration.
For now, it's just co-op exploration.
There's no problem with the haunt roll, and we're good.
It is now the David's turn.
Uh-oh.
Don't worry, he's just gonna finish this thing and then he'll be fine.
Can you shock me off the paper? They still could have gotten here. What is this? How does this work? I don't know either.
Everyone needs to chill out.
Everyone's chilled at you.
Yeah, David, you're the one that's stressing right now.
David, put the gun down.
Do you think I feel something?
Too soon. Civil War. Oh, damn, I forgot about
so
Civil War.
So is Civil War
triggered? I don't know, it's just that... It takes me back to the time when there were just muskets being loaded and fired. And
have you ever been to a Civil War reenactment?
He was in the Civil War, David.
Nope, because here's my version of me being in the Civil War reenactment. I'm in the house cooking for the white people.
That we should add that in Civil War reenactments because that would end them immediately. Like
it would.
Hey, oh, by yeah. the way, so
it would.
For
would.
Accuracy,
why don't we put all the black people
have
in the kitchen?
Have slaves. That's illegal. Everything's done.
Well,
anyway.
I think a majority of the people that go to these Civil War reenactments would see, like, slaves and just be like, whoa.
That would be so fun to watch.
Can you imagine? Watching people be real awkward, just like,
watching on
I actually, can you just go ahead and black my name out completely? I want no record of me being a part of this.
This is an amazing candid camera idea. Like dads showing up, you know, and then they just see, like, people in shackles.
Oh my god!
Like little kids are just like, Mommy!
Oh
my god. Anyway,
Tim, is this what you do with your weekends?
Think about how many millions of dollars are wasted on Civil War reenactments every year.
Probably a lot. The costumes are insane.
When you could just donate that to me. look,
and there it
better
is.
Use of your money. So
submit. You know, submit. Anyway, David, it is your turn.
What do I do with that?
What's your speed?
Okay.
Look at your little dial thingy.
Four.
Four. So you can move four spaces. I do not recommend going into the junk room.
Down the patio.
So I see. So every time,
you
guys
open
are exploring,
a new...
and now I know what those rooms are.
Yes.
Well, I already hate Brandon, so let's
get him dead.
The poor little boy. He's in the green.
You're the green.
Short.
Like, so he's gonna.
So you'll go here?
You can only hit one room at a time.
Okay.
So once you open a room, your turn ends regardless of your speed.
Once you draw a card.
Collapse room.
If you enter a room where you have to draw a card.
Where you have to draw a card, you're right.
He ended the collapse room.
The collapse room.
Oh no!
So, I have to attempt a speed roll of 5 plus to avoid falling.
Yet your speed is 4.
Your speed is pretty high, isn't it?
Well, it's 4.
If
you roll 4
fail
dice.
The roll, draw a basement tile. I almost thought that said title.
Tile.
Put it in play.
Oh, and you can fall into the basement.
Mm-hmm.
One die of physical damage. D-I-E. Wow. Rough day for Brandon.
Rough day for Brandon. Unless he's fast.
Okay, so
roll
I need
so let's see if he can run away.
Can I just ask why a child is in this mansion? Who let this happen?
There's
where are the parents?
His name is Brandon. You
so
brought
wait,
him.
Wait, wait, wait. Is the speed roll?
Oh, yeah, I did bring
wait,
him.
Wait, wait, wait.
I met him on Craigslist.
He
has to roll a 5.
If he's leaving the room?
No,
period?
It's immediately.
So does he have to leave the room immediately after this?
He'll stay in the room. He's fine. If he succeeds
okay.
the speed test, he's fine. And then he can continue moving.
But he
on.
Can continue moving as long as he makes it through the speed test.
You succeeded.
How
yay.
Can he continue moving in that room? There's a giant hole in
you
the middle.
Go around.
He ran
he's,
out.
He's that
there's
fast.
Edges.
He's really fast. He's brand.
That's
he's my he little brother, dude.
That's not how science works.
Dude, he's my little brother.
Okay, so are you gonna
like,
keep exploring,
flash.
Get another card? Get another room.
Okay, so I could literally just keep going.
You can go one
going.
More. You have one more. No, you have two more rooms. Spaces you can move if you want.
So you can go.
As long as you don't hit a room with a card draw in it.
Yeah.
I just kind of want to know how all these people just ended up in the same
place.
Just
like, let's go explore this house, guys.
Like, is this a roadside attraction?
Maybe.
Well, okay, anyway, we've since we got a 21-year-old,
so
a 9-year-old.
My choices are
37, 21,
explore more, or go back into the main hallway.
Go back into the main hallway. Well, Brandon's, he's got something to prove because he's 5'1", so let's explore more.
He's taller than me.
I'm in character 5'1", and he's 9 years old?
Which way did you go to?
Are you serious?
Geez.
This way.
This way towards you.
Towards him.
All right, you're moving here now.
So what's the next room?
Dining room.
Oh, that's nice. What's in the dining room?
Little fucker's gonna eat, probably.
All right, in the dining room, you draw an omen card.
Why?
Because
there's an omen in there.
Oh.
A symbol.
So read it for us.
Skull.
Oh, dear.
A skull, cracked and missing teeth. If you take mental damage, you can take all of it as physical damage instead.
Oh, that's kind of nice.
Hello, Henry. Make a haunt roll now.
Yep, that is the haunt check. Roll 6.
How many do I... Okay.
Yeah.
So what you need to do now is roll 2 or higher.
Because there are 2 omen cards.
That would be extremely unlikely.
Exactly.
Well, each one has 2 blank sides. It's not impossible.
Oh my god.
You rolled a 3, David.
I saw so many blank dice.
I did too. Yeah. I was like, God damn it, David.
So if I had
one
rolled a 2, then I
Cthulhu.
We would reveal what's called the traitor. Someone in this house is a traitor.
Yeah. Someone in this house lured all of us here.
I saw Will Wheaton do this.
Yes, you did.
Will Wheaton did do
on
this.
On her table.
I thought you were Will Wheaton.
Will Wheaton did play this game, and he was the traitor.
Are you serious?
What?
Will Wheaton was the... I'm dead
serious.
That was
this game?
That was this game.
Tabletop 4. Yeah, that's really, really weird because that's the only tabletop episode I've watched. Was Felicia Day on that episode?
Yes, I believe
probably.
She was.
I mean, I'm pretty sure her and Will Wheaton had a
Wait,
thing.
Is this the game we were watching?
Yeah.
Oh, I wasn't really paying attention.
You were drunk.
Yes.
The game we were watching that Will Wheaton was playing was the Cthulhu.
Oh, yeah. No, that was a different one. That was the dice one.
Okay.
That
this
was the...
is really strange. I'm sorry. That
it is now,
are you having Inception?
Professor Longfellow's turn.
But it is strange.
But it is
more like deja vu.
Grandpa has a speed of 4.
I kind of want to follow Brandon.
You just want to go with Brandon?
Because, I mean...
Whoa, creepy.
You
we did meet on Craigslist, and he did promise a good time.
I believe you have to... roll that, do the
are there any
do that
bedrooms?
Like, every time you enter that room, every time you someone
yes,
enters that room.
With these options.
Wait, it's a re-roll.
Are those
I
all
mean,
rooms?
Not.
Those
maybe
are
not.
All
no,
rooms.
Maybe,
there are not that many types of room.
There's, well, because there's like a
basement and
basement,
upper
floor and a ground floor.
Nope, I think I'm going to stay away
there's
from Brandon.
There's like 100
okay.
cards there.
I'm gonna
I cannot
go the other
name
way.
100
just so people don't realize what's actually going on, I'm going to go this way.
There's
okay, top card.
Closet. Dining room, kitchen.
There's an organ
ooh, the
room,
game
if I recall.
The game
ooh.
Room.
Game room, very oops. Nice.
So, by the way this works, see how there's no door here? That makes this a false door.
What does that mean?
Well,
bloody
you could
vision.
Turn it so all the doors are
I mean,
accessible.
Would you like to turn it
you
that
could
way?
Turn
what?
It.
Would you like to turn it so all the doors are accessible?
Yeah.
Okay. This
okay,
is
so,
an event.
What if, can we
event.
Just change this, move this one? Turn
oh.
this one?
You can't, it's already set.
It's already set.
Oh.
How do people remember?
What happens with false doors, though?
They're just dead ends.
Wait.
Yeah, I mean, a false
oh,
door is just you
the
open
top.
The door and then
what?
The wall.
That somehow ended up on the top. That's
thank
hers.
You. Thank
oh.
You. David.
I just thought I might have
damn it! Oh, no!
What?
I fucking hate these things.
What is it?
Creepy puppet. I hate fucking dolls.
Actual fear.
Yes, I hate dolls. There was a doll one time that happened in this house. Burnt the shed. Salted and said a prayer.
I was going to say, that was my first solution is we burn it.
Yeah, we burned
we
it.
Did.
We
did. We actually
I
did.
Well, I did. Now,
burnt the shit out of it.
Burn that
not burn it.
Okay.
Fire is a wonderful right. solution. To
creepy
anything.
Puppet.
Okay.
You see one of these dolls that give you the willies. Fucking Annabelle.
Oh, God.
It jumps at you with a tiny spear. Where
I'm
the fuck does a doll
movie?
Get a tiny spear? The player on your right rolls a might 4 attack. You're on my little... Oh, yeah, so... For the creepy puppet, you defend against the attack as normal by rolling dice equal to your might. If you take any damage from this attack, the explorer with the spear gains 2 might, but no, I don't think anyone has a spear.
Yeah, that would be only...
Shit!
Oh
my
fuck.
God!
What happened?
David rolled
one
as
wondering.
High as possible.
He rolled the highest, which is...
8.
8 here, yeah.
What does that
and
mean?
What is that doing again? I forgot.
And
you're attacking him as the puppet.
Thanks.
You are pretending to be the puppet right now for the dice.
I was
and you just
say,
killed him. No, I don't know if that's true.
So, you take a total of 5 damage. Divided between your speed and your might. That's
fucking puppets.
Sucks.
Oh my God.
I still can't believe we're playing that the same game that Will Wheaton played. Honestly, this is really weird because that's
so
only,
it's my might and my
yeah,
speed.
So your might and speed.
See, and also Game Grumps has played it with Markiplier and all them.
But like that
but
episode of TableTop is the only full game like this that I've ever watched ever, unless you count Candyland.
Three.
We should do Candyland next episode.
I think
down.
That was a joke.
Down.
I'm only if we're gonna like role play.
I'm fucked already.
Thanks,
Holy
David.
Shit. Sorry. I mean, it is Brandon. He's 12 years old. You know.
You promised a good time.
Craigslist. You're still on that. This
yes.
is like.
I didn't know Craigslist was.
No, we were on the Craigslist. You were like, oh, my name is Brandon. I'm 5'1". I have a skater's body. And I was like, okay, Brandon, I'm Professor Longfellow. Would you like to see?
What is this? Skater's body?
I don't know.
Wow.
I went with it.
I feel like I may have a skater's body, and that it's just.
So you promised right.
Skinny white
you delivered.
Boy.
You delivered.
With a little bit of
except
a belly
for the good time
now.
Part. That was not delivered. You failed on that part.
Okay.
I think I'm done with the
anyway.
Whole Craigslist thing.
So, AJ, but AJ, you can't die in this phase. So.
Sure. You can't die during the exploration phase. So you have a chance to get your speed and stuff back.
Good.
Like, there's medkits
yeah.
and stuff.
Yippee skippy. I hope I get one of those. Probably not. Probably gonna get another fucking event where good old Mr. David here, who can just roll all the magic shit, is gonna fuck me.
Thank you, David.
I just...
Take your fucking skull.
I just dropped the cubes
because
I was supposed
chill.
To.
It's not that deep.
For one rotation.
It's not that deep. Chill.
Terry hasn't even gone.
I haven't even gone yet. Everything's gone to hell.
Go, Terry.
This is fucking fun.
Brandon. See, if I were to
it's Darren Flash Williams' turn.
If I were to make a game, the it would just be a box full of cubes.
One, two.
A box full of cubes.
And you'd have
Mystery to Elevator.
Oh, boy. Ooh, what's that mean?
Okay.
Please read it.
Mystery Elevator. Once per turn, roll 2 dice and move this room next to any open door on 4, any floor, 3, upper floor, 2, ground floor,
why
1, basement,
like
0, basement and take 1 dice.
Carrying capacity.
Carrying capacity is 253 pounds.
What's that? Oh.
Wait, for reals?
Is that actually what it says?
No.
Oh, see, that'd be awesome.
If I made this game, I would specify.
I would specify.
Yeah, well, because they have weights. Why wouldn't they do that? That'd be hilarious.
Backing
like
up.
People can't use it.
Going this direction.
That'd be so complicated.
You could ruin this game.
Too many.
Where are you going?
It's too deep.
Back here.
We need to get Cooper. I need to get Cooper in front of a camera.
Oh, so you chose not to use the elevator.
Yes.
Gotcha.
Charred room.
Lovely.
I draw an omen card.
I guess there are maybe 100 types of
the rules. Madman.
About.
Companion. A raving, frothing madman, a.k.a. David.
I don't froth.
I gain 2 might and lose 1 sanity now.
I'm subtly mad.
So you suddenly mad?
Subtly.
Subtly.
Suddenly Seymour?
I don't froth.
That's not true.
I have never frothed, okay?
You're frothing right now.
No way.
Yep.
Define.
That's froth.
Yeah, I don't really know.
I will define
like how
frothing.
Specify
it's
frothing.
It's your turn.
I'm gonna define
it's
it.
It's your turn.
After
Greg.
I define it.
Greg!
The audience wants to know.
Did you make a halt roll? Oh, no,
hold
I didn't.
Hold on.
Jim, Bob, George, Greg.
Well, the haunt begins.
Oh,
no!
Fucking
all ready. Fucking ready? We have a...
Can we leave? We can't leave.
Okay, so.
So, we will be deciding.
It's the madman. In the charred room.
What is this?
We're determining the
home.
You
have an app?
I do.
There's an app for this?
There is.
There's an app for that.
Traitor.
On Android, no
less. None.
None? There's no traitor?
There's no traitor. The haunt is airborne, number 31.
Fuck no.
Yep.
Oh, God, not zombies,
so this
please.
Is this a disease?
What? It's zombies.
There's no traitor.
I hate zombies, though.
A deafening shriek leaves you reeling. A second later, the house seems to crumple and then jerk into the air. But that would be crazy. You rush to the window and see the madness is true. A bird the size of a 747 is carrying the house in its talons, presumably to feed its monstrous blood somewhere. Anyway, beneath you, the ground gets farther and farther away. If you are going to live, you need to get out of this house fast. But you need some way to survive the fall.
How intelligent is the bird?
You remember one of your friends mentioning some parachutes they stumbled over. You just need to find one. There might not be enough for everyone, but surely the others would agree that you deserve one.
So you're implying the coconut's mine.
Are we fighting each other for the parachute item? Oh my god, this is
right
stupid.
Now,
why'd you pick this
So the creators
one?
Of this house, or the occupants, knew that there's just this giant bird that may come by and...
Apparently.
What an interesting world this place is.
The haunt is determined by the omen that I and the room that I
didn't know there were
omen.
Birds that big.
Okay, so we need the survival guide.
I don't think
guide.
There are, to be honest.
Yeah, I have it right here.
Exactly, okay, this is nonsensical.
Set aside
I'm
a number of hexagonal item tokens.
What's happening?
Equal to half the number of players rounding down.
How many of us are
two.
There?
There
There's
are.
There's five of us, so we only get two.
There's only two parachutes.
Can I voluntarily jump?
There's five of us. There's two and a half.
They said round down.
But they said round down. Down.
We don't get half a parachute.
Can
we
I,
should.
Can I reason with the bird? No, this is a legitimate question.
This is why David doesn't play board games.
Look, there's a bird the size of the 747. It is not unreasonable.
It is unreasonable.
To ask.
This
speaks,
whole thing is unreasonable,
if it
David.
Speaks I know.
Remove any basement tiles in the house.
The basement has left. Okay, that's great.
If any explorers are in the basement, put them in the Mystic Elevator and put that tile beside any ground floor door.
Mystic Elevator.
Search the room stack for it if it's not in play. Then place it on the ground or upper floor, then shuffle that stack. What you know about the bad guys. This haunt has no traitor, only heroes. Even so, only some of you can survive. You win when you exit the house with a parachute. Heroes who do not find a parachute are killed.
Oh my god.
Finding a parachute. Heroes can still explore the house and find new rooms. They cannot enter the basement, however. If the next room tile they go into is... Go in that. If the next tile can only go in the basement, put it in the discard pile and draw tiles until you can place one. Several parachutes are hidden in the house. You can search for a parachute by making a knowledge or speed roll of 4+ in any room with an omen symbol. If you succeed on this roll, take a parachute token and put it on your character card. Only one parachute can be found in a given room. You cannot move any further on the turn you find or steal a parachute. You can carry only one parachute at a time. Special attack rules. You can steal a parachute from another hero by attacking with might, resisted by might as usual. Or tricking your opponent with knowledge, resisted by knowledge. Unlike the normal rules for stealing items, you can take the parachute if you win by one or more. The loser does not take any damage. The attacker's turn then ends, whether or not the attack was successful. You can attack other heroes to inflict damage instead of stealing a parachute using the normal rules. A dead hero carrying a parachute drops it, and any other hero can pick it up. Heroes slow each other as if they were monsters. I don't know what that means.
So, other players are monsters.
Currently. Once you have a parachute, you can exit the house.
They're your enemies. Everyone's our enemy.
You can exit the house once you have a parachute, you can exit the house. To do this, move to the entrance hall, balcony, tower, coal chute, or collapsed room, and spend one space of movement. Then make a knowledge roll to make sure you know how it works, or a sanity roll to psych yourself up of 4+. On a success, you exit safely.
This is ridiculous.
If you win. If you lose. All right.
This photograph. I wasn't
can
even.
I see it?
Every time
I
do it makes me laugh.
I was trying to make a weird face. I think it worked.
Thank
what
you.
What happened?
Look at this graph! Look at this. No, it's like, look at this graph.
It's like, so out of tune because they cut the.
Yes. It's so, it sounds so sad. It's just like, okay, this photograph, actually, I wasn't intending on taking a funny photograph.
But it happened.
It is legitimately hilarious.
Let's see it. Share it with the class.
It's, okay.
Is it,
hurry,
is
hurry,
it,
hurry,
why
is
are
it
we talking about photographs when there's a giant bird and we're in a house? I'm just wondering.
Yeah, we're all fucked.
Well, looks like we're going to have
ask
time for a second game.
Well, it's time to kill each other, folks.
Nice.
No, look closer.
I like this.
Look at everyone.
Everyone's so pissed.
It's like...
I like that.
I like that. I like the skull in the corner. That's, like, really
like
well done.
That.
He's like that photo bomber that's like...
He is a photo bomber, Henry.
It's an inanimate object.
Okay, so...
Anyway, so... So, my turn immediately... My movement ends, yes?
Yeah, you drew a card and you also
so
started
I'm done.
The haunt.
That's so cool.
Way to go, Terry.
Hi.
What up?
So, it's Greg's turn.
Greg's turn.
It is Greg's turn. What do I do?
Greg?
Where are you gonna move?
Well, she's already in... Where are you? You're up there. Never mind. You need to move... Okay, so we have three rooms that are omens. In order to win, you need to get to one of these rooms, make a speed test...
You can also find a new room that has an omen.
That's true. You can also find a new room that has an omen. But once you do, once you draw that card, your turn ends.
True.
So.
So the room has to already be.
Yes, and
so you not only have to go into a room with an omen sign, find a parachute, but you have to get away without somebody stealing it from you.
Yes. Or killing you.
Or killing you.
And once you go into the room.
None of us really have
get a parachute, your turn stops, so you can't just turn around and go.
Nope.
Correct.
Damn it.
Yeah, I know.
I have, like, nothing. Thanks, Terry.
Why is this my fault? I did the...
Yeah.
Wow, okay, so... There's a lot of rolling things in this section for this one, particularly.
So, Greg?
So, Greg, what you gonna do? What's he gonna do, Greg?
Should I just go into this one?
Well, can you move that far?
Yeah.
Looks like you can. Three. You have three. One, two, three. So yeah, you can totally come to that one. Okay, so she's gonna try to steal this omen's
room. Do the rules of the junk room still apply that she walked in there?
Oh, that's true. She
Wait,
did go
that's not
the
what
junk.
I wanted to do then. I'm gonna
she
do
takes it back.
To You're gonna go to the charred room.
Charred room.
Can't.
So.
Not yet. I would get
Oh, yeah, no, you don't have enough movement for it. You only have enough movement to make it to mine.
I don't see how this... I don't see anything about slowing.
Well, it happens in the junk room.
If you try and leave, you have to make a speed check of 3+.
That sounds like difficult.
A little bit difficult.
What happens if I go into the same room you're in, the game room?
Nothing.
Nothing? So...
You can't make it there, though.
I asked Will Wheaton if we can reason with the bird.
You can make it
what
there,
does he say?
But you don't get to look for the omen.
He's not really
a... But you're moving towards the omen.
If you did, I'd be really impressed.
You just might.
It'll probably be like a year.
So next turn. So Greg's done.
Well, I think we need to decide what bird it is, because...
No.
We're still stuck
what's
on the
much
bird.
What's much more important than the species
it's
is...
It's an African swallow.
Can we reason with it?
No, and you cannot reason with
it. African swallow?
Yes. Are you saying that as
Yeah, I'm saying that
as
the
authority.
I am the authority.
What's
is it carrying
the big man in the game? What's the big man in the game called?
It was carrying a house.
The GM.
Same thing.
Yeah, but there's another cooler name.
The House
Game
of
Master?
Coconut.
Yeah,
well,
that's just that's an acronym. I know what acronyms are.
So, what are acronyms?
Okay.
So what would be the cooler name?
For what?
It's
the administrator?
No, but okay.
The admin?
Sorry, I'm holding us up.
You
what are
holding.
We talking about?
I don't really
know. So sorry. Yep.
Okay, so.
I'm trying to be good at the game.
Terry, if I wanted to roll for the parachute that possibly is in my room.
Yes.
What is it again?
It's a knowledge check.
It's a knowledge check?
It is either a... Where is that thing at? Oh, okay, so it's a speed roll 4+, or a knowledge roll 4+.
I think I'm going to go for a speed attempt. So I get 4 dice.
Speed is always the answer.
Speed is always the answer. So I have to get 4+.
Ain't that the truth. Roll the cubes.
I don't make it. Nope. What happens if I don't make it?
That's it.
That's it?
Yep.
I can still move, though.
Nope.
No, my turn ends.
Turn ends. Brandon?
Okay,
You're lucky. You're in a room that has...
Yep.
An omen as well.
So, speed or knowledge?
Do I have to... I have to call it now, don't I?
Yes.
What yeah, but if you... Okay, so if you roll for your speed, whatever your speed number is... Because isn't your speed 5
four.
Or 4?
It's 4.
Your score is 4. What's your knowledge?
3.
Yeah, so, he's only saying...
So, yeah, speed is always the answer. It's
speed
Brandon.
Is always the answer. Go!
It's Brandon.
Wow.
Brandon dies.
Why couldn't you have done that when you were attacking him?
Yeah.
Well.
Just saying.
Okay, anyway. So Brandon got 1, so he's done.
Professor?
Professor!
Yeah, we're actually probably definitely going to have time for another game.
You think so?
We cannot forget.
It is 12:37.
Skater body.
Some of us have class in the morning.
What's that?
You're staying.
Yeah. Oh my god.
So I get 5.
That is a bit.
Okay, so you get 5, you roll in with knowledge?
Yep.
4.
4.
He
you
succeeded.
Get a parachute.
You're taking the parachute.
Just explain to your professor. The big bird came, the cubes lied, and we
could The cubes lied.
Just say
we
you
could
were talking.
Not, we could not reason with the bird.
All
work.
The sense.
It'll work.
The bird?
Actually, I can check what I have to do for my class.
Just send,
yeah,
send
code,
your
no,
professor.
Do you spend all
don't fucking take my parachute. You there's another room you can go to. You can look for your own damn parachute.
Send all
the no, here's the thing though.
So
you
can there
fucked
not be
us.
Two parachutes
you
in
get
one
your
room?
Own damn parachute. Let me have this one.
Can there not be two parachutes in one room?
No,
I don't know.
You can only get one per room.
Damn
then, have we specified our altitude?
I don't think that matters.
It does, though.
This is the problem with me in games. The answer, the best course of action is always to give up or leave. Like, really, when we entered this house, we should have been like, okay, not a good idea. Leave.
Probably. I'm still trying to figure out the group of people.
Why are you staring at the top of the ceiling? Like,
it's random.
I think you're literally trying to talk to the bird right now.
That's 9-year-old logic.
Are you implying that he is a traitor?
No, I'm just saying he's trying to converse with the bird.
Wait, is this something I should have decided?
No.
If you were the traitor?
The traitor knows who the traitor is.
There is no traitor. The bird is the traitor.
There is no traitor. We all just all just got fucked.
Oh, so you can go ahead and try to take the...
Oh, no.
So, Terry, what you doing?
I'm making a speed check.
To see if you can take the thing?
So there,
oh, no, he's over here with me.
There for real is no traitor, right?
Shit.
Yeah.
Okay, so
well,
Terry's got the other parachute.
I've got
I know who I'm killing.
I'm really fast.
Kill the bird!
Kill the bird! Drop the house. Kill the bird.
Then we
so
all die.
Me and
Good.
Terry have the only two parachutes in the house.
Correct.
Now what?
So
we
there's
now
no
targets.
More parachutes. Time to kill people.
We are now targets.
No, but now what? Now what? Now what? Now what?
Now
how do you...
you have to try and steal a parachute from people.
How?
Well, who
well,
are
how?
You need
speed.
To decide
who
on
do you
well,
want
obviously
speed.
Him.
Who's
so
him?
So you're going for
AJ?
KJ.
Okay. What?
Yeah, but how do I
we'll
attack him?
You have to go into the room with him. Step one.
We'll learn how first.
Okay.
So now.
Now you can attempt to steal a parachute from another hero by attacking with might, resisted by might as usual. So you roll your might, your three dice for, or your
four
versus his.
No. It says I can resist with knowledge.
You resist a knowledge by knowledge, but a might with might.
That's bullshit.
No.
Resist
what's
with
your
speed.
Might three. Ha.
Actually, resisting with speed.
My might is one.
Because the
oh,
idea.
Oh yes,
is...
that's why I chose you.
Okay, let's go. Roll off. Go.
Come on,
but wait,
all
what
zeros.
Happens though? What happens?
Well, if you beat him, you get the parachute.
You kill him and he...
You don't kill
I just have to have a higher
him.
Number.
He doesn't take any damage from it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So I just have to have a higher number.
Yes.
Wait.
So why do we, like, is there an indication that we're going to be falling soon, or are we just going... Well, no, like, seriously, because if the house is going to remain intact, then why do we need a parachute?
The bird is going to eat us.
I think it's taking us
it's
to
taking
nest
us
for
to
a
his
yeah,
young
he's
one.
Taking
nest.
Us to the nest so he can devour us.
Okay
you're,
yeah.
So you're done.
But probably not immediately,
yeah,
so we got
you just
time.
Wanted to roll the dice.
Well, I'm just assuming that the bird
well,
has
hey, Terry.
Babies,
hi.
And they will immediately eat.
Where are your stats at?
That's
my might is five, my knowledge is three.
Have you ever seen A Bug's Life?
I'm super smart.
My knowledge
you know
is
when
also
the bird
three,
gets
though.
There with the cricket?
Yep.
And the cricket dies, or the grasshopper dies? Yep,
above
or the grasshopper.
I'm gonna try and outsmart you.
A lot of
go.
Life lessons.
Alright,
yes.
3v3.
3v3?
I'm probably here today because of A Bug's Life.
Shit.
Yes.
She
give
stole
me cool. The
girl's rule.
I think the biggest
boys
life lesson
rule.
I learned from A Bug's Life.
See, now we're just gonna keep stealing
it,
the
I'm a beautiful butterfly.
There you go.
That's the
did
biggest
you
one
stuff
I learned.
In that room?
Yeah.
See, the morality
hang on.
And the
before
benefit
you...
of vanity.
Oops, I did
that's
nice.
I didn't
that's
go
always
there.
Nice.
That's
yeah,
why I wanted to
and have vanity can
well,
also overcome
that's
some
how
of the
goes.
Most difficult things.
I want to make sure that you can't. I
yeah.
want
can't
to
move after.
Learning that being weird is not a bad thing.
I did that wrong.
Yeah.
You oh. did that wrong.
Oops. Yeah.
Is that
odd?
Especially
big
after?
In the 90s.
Yeah. No. Hang on.
Being an
no,
odd duck
I
might just you know
change the haunt.
Lead you oops. To saving the entire colony.
There you go.
And gaining some really cool friends yeah, along the way.
Yep.
So.
There's so much happening right now.
A Bug's Life was amazing.
Yes.
It really was.
That's a great movie.
The attacker's turn then
I've got
ends,
the game on
the
PS1.
Successful.
What?
I used to have that game.
It's
it was great.
Game.
It was great.
No, it's a terrible
so wait,
game.
Okay,
the best part is whenever you have to fly the little dandelion across the gorge, because you always die.
What level
always.
Bad? Final Fantasy X-2 bad or E.T. Atari bad?
He would not get either of those
never
references.
Mind.
No, I know E.T. Atari. Well, I know what both. I've never played either.
It's your turn, by the way, Brandon.
It's broken. Do I need cubes?
Not yet, unless you intend.
So wait, can we move after
you cannot. Your turn
you
ends.
Definitely cannot. So you're just going to keep hitting at me.
Basically, you have to hope that the person fails to get you and then your turn happens. Or you can just try and kill each other. That is an option.
Can I fight with knowledge?
Wait, how do we
nope.
kill each other
fight
then?
With speed.
Fight with might. Speed. Instead of attempting to steal, you attempt to actually hurt.
Gotcha. Got it. I got it now. Okay.
That's inefficient. What do I need to declare?
Well, you need to move
major,
first.
War.
Kidding.
You need to move to someone who
war,
has a parachute.
War.
Or you can keep exploring the house and gather material.
So, okay, is there
technically.
Is there possibly another parachute in
no.
the house?
No.
So...
What are you doing?
This is a cruel game of Scream.
Why, hello, Terry.
Hello.
How are you?
I mean, considering...
Well,
I think I'll keep exploring.
What's going on down there?
I think I'll keep exploring.
Okay.
Technically, I haven't seen anything that we we haven't violated YouTube's explicit stuff. So
is
we're
it
still good.
What is the?
So I can show my tatas.
I cursed.
No, that maybe.
I cursed once.
I cursed.
Oh no!
I
cursing
cursed.
Is fine.
Cursing is
we
fine.
Cursed.
What's the?
It's just we can't. We probably
it's,
just can't really.
No, nothing pornographic.
Nudity, if it's for art, definitely no sexual intercourse.
Oh, well, that's
darn.
So...
Just kidding. Kidding.
Get out of here!
Kidding!
You're my daughter!
Explain that one.
So pulling out my boobies off the table.
Okay, all right, let's,
okay,
let's move
okay.
on.
Okay.
And again.
It's not
where
a...
Is
so where are you going?
Where did you go?
Where are you going?
Look.
How
Look,
the fuck
I
did you...
I not question.
Way the fuck over there!
You know, that's just my instinct.
Like it's way.
So I'm guessing you're going
Were
that
you
way.
Talking to the bird? Did the bird tell you right. to do this?
Look, a hallway.
Hang on.
But he can keep moving.
Yep, he can keep moving.
I'm going to sit
nope.
in that.
Which
Why?
Direction are you going to go?
That's where
you're
you stop.
Keep going that
Why
way.
Can he
you
keep
stopped.
Moving?
You stopped where?
In a conservatory. Yes.
Lovely.
Why can he keep moving?
Some really heavy
did
marble.
Nothing happened in that room.
If you don't hit a card draw, you can keep moving.
Current thought. Satisfied looking at the marble, knowing that this bird is having to heft. All that marble.
Well, this is kind of funny because we have a bird.
Jonah's okay. turn.
Yes, we do.
Two boys are playing with a wooden top.
What?
Would you like a turn, Jonah? One asks. No, says Jonah. I want all the turns. That's an interesting response. Jonah takes the top and hits the other boy in the face. The boy falls. Jonah keeps hitting him as they fade from view. Why would they fade?
They're ghosts.
Am I losing consciousness?
Are they ghosts?
Yes, they're ghosts.
If an explorer has the puzzle box, that explorer discards that item. I don't know what the puzzle box is.
There is no puzzle box out.
Draws a replacement item for it. If this happens, you gain one sanity. Otherwise, you take one die of mental damage.
Where are Ooh. The parents?
So I haven't died?
No,
no you're alive.
Are you trying to die?
I mean, I don't know. Honestly.
It's gonna take a fucked up
so
person
need,
to kill a child.
I need
child.
To roll this cube.
Yes, you need to roll that cube. You take no damage.
Cool.
Congrats.
Okay. It's now Professor Einhart's turn.
So that was just a thing that happened, and mm-hmm. no one cares
Long
about Jonah anymore.
I'm gonna try
nope.
to steal your parachute.
Jonah's dead.
Cool.
I can do it with knowledge, right?
Yes.
Yes.
No, says Jonah. I want all the
I have
terms.
Five knowledge.
He needs one more.
That
sounds like how we should play this game.
Sounds like what?
Huh?
How should we play this game?
No, I want all the turns.
Oh.
Two.
Two.
So now she right? has to roll hers.
I have
yep.
to roll at least.
So he got two. Two!
What if we're both two? Do we
then it's a draw.
It again?
It's a draw.
So I get to keep it?
No.
No.
Oh, yes,
Wait,
you,
yes
you do
keep
get
it.
To keep it.
It's a meter beat. No, it's beat. You have to beat.
What is she keeping?
The parachute.
Cool.
It's now my turn.
What an interesting conflict over parachutes.
My four.
I know, right?
Oh, I have my five. Yeah.
Hi, Terry.
After all this time, wouldn't you think that the bird would have already got us back to his house?
I'm going to try
how far
and
away
wrestle this parachute from you.
It's true, this is
so
cool.
Who knows? I mean, this bird
I'm
is...
I'm mighting you.
This bird
I
is the size
four.
Of an aircraft.
I need
a large aircraft.
Are you... Aren't you three?
I'm
oh,
five.
No, you have the thing.
I have the madman.
Who knows what its motivations
okay.
are?
Okay, really? So I have to roll...
Who knows where you... Like, where are we
three,
going?
Three, four.
Yeah. There... I don't think there's... We have no basis to make a decision.
Four.
Five.
Once
five,
we've acknowledged
damn it.
That the bird
Take
is the size
it.
Of a 747.
But you
How
thought
did
we
not know that there was a bird
so
like this in existence?
Yes.
I would have thought that somewhere they would have found this out.
They should have specified.
I steal
levels.
It with my, if I, if
By
I
the
attack
way,
you, if I specifically attack
Oh, you have
bird.
To say you're attacking
yeah.
so with my
National Geographic should have informed
Greg,
us on
at this point, you can
I'm
try and get out of the
sure if there was a 747 sized bird, it would be.
You move.
I don't think anyone
it would
knows
not
what's
be
going
ignored.
On anymore.
Here.
No, I don't think you could ignore it. Like, oh, mom, look, look at that bird.
How to
it's
use
as big
a
as a plate.
Or
it's, yeah,
you make a sanity
too.
Check to psych yourself up to
big
escape.
Big bird. I'm thinking it would probably be something like a hawk or an eagle.
On,
similar like the one at Rescue Rescuers.
Are we still talking about the damn bird over there?
Yes.
I have to get four.
It's cold.
Yeah, on a knowledge or sanity. Four.
No, this is the thing
so
we're trying
it's
to...
a 747 size.
Well, no, you need
yes.
to roll four.
So it's raised.
Yeah,
that makes,
raised.
It, that makes it a bit easier.
What,
the thing that we're talking about, though, is
four,
why weren't we informed?
Imagine or how slow its heart rate would be.
Right?
Yeah.
You
no.
fail.
Like
now,
one
beat.
Because like
is,
a whale's heart rate's like four beats per minute.
here, stuck.
And it's basically more or less safely. In nature, with especially with mammals.
So you actually
the bigger the animal, the slower.
I think you just died.
So I just died.
What? What happened?
Because it says on a success, you exit safely. She failed.
She fell through the basement.
Oh, come on. For death, it has to specify.
What it doesn't say.
But
it
the
just
thing
says,
is, okay, she's in the collapse room?
She's right here.
Wait, I survived. What?
Wait, she has a parachute and she just left the house?
Exiting the house. Once you have a parachute, you can exit the house. To do this, move to the entrance hall, balcony, tower, coal chute, or collapsed room and spend one space of movement. Then make a knowledge roll to make sure you know how it works, or sanity roll to psych yourself up. Of 4+. On success, you exit safely. So I guess you fail.
You died.
If you fell.
Or she didn't go.
Or you didn't go. So it depends on if you made a sanity or
I'm
a knowledge
I'm thinking didn't
check.
Go.
Well, yeah, because it would specify if you...
It would say, if not,
you
are out of the game.
You didn't go. So now you're there.
I'm still there.
Yeah, you're still there. We'll say you're still there.
Okay.
Okay. I'm still stuck on this bird situation.
Oh my god.
Why?
This is ridiculous.
I'm not stuck on it, but it is curious.
You're Terry.
What?
Like I'm gonna try and leave the junk room.
I have
how?
What?
How do I leave the junk room
again?
You have
to make a 3+ speed.
3 or more speed.
So I can go out to the hallway and steal her.
Well, either way, I'm going to roll my 4 for my might and hopefully get enough to leave. I'm good, so I leave, and I'm coming over to here. Hi, Caitlin.
Is your turn over, though?
No.
She's going to try and steal your parachute.
I'm going to...
Run past her? And
Terry, did you... Oh, no, you didn't.
I'm going to go speed against you and try to...
Run past her into the void.
Raffle it from you.
She's going to try and take it from her so that she's already in that room.
Oh, I see.
Shit. Caitlin keeps it.
Yes.
And that's it for me.
Well, Brandon, it is your turn. You were kind of in a far-off direction.
Wee little lad.
Wait, I can't continue, can I?
No.
You can't go forward anymore, but you can go to another off-shooting room off of that hallway.
It does show you what an odd duck this child is.
He's just running out. Like, there's a bird carrying us off. He's like, I want to go see more of this house.
Forget the parachutes. All the adults are fighting over the... Oh, fun. That's
what?
Where you can run
One
from.
One-way slide to basement landing.
But he can't go to the basement.
But you can't go to the
basement. So I die.
So that actually gets discarded.
Well, didn't it say that the coal chute is one of the places you can leave
from? Yeah, but it said if you draw a card that can only go to the basement, you discard it and you keep drawing until you get something else.
But in all, it really should just be instant death.
Nope, just get a ballroom.
It should be, but...
A ballroom. What's an event?
I think they try to avoid instant death because you would.
Yeah.
Yeah, you get an event card.
Oh my, this is a coal chute. I think you'd identify the coal chute first
before you jump. Yeah.
In theory.
To your death.
I don't know, it kind of depends.
The voice...
Oh dear.
Oh, great.
I'm under the floor, buried under the floor. The voice whispers once, then is gone. You must attempt a knowledge roll. For 4+, you find something under the floor, draw an item card. For 0 to 3, you dig and search for the voice, but to no avail. So clearly I want to... option 3, I yell, please visit wumo.com.
So it's a... Oh, you roll 3.
Wumo.com.
I'm under the floor, buried under the floor. Wumo.com. Well, you're under there. So I
fail.
Spend my time digging, right?
And finding nothing, it looks like.
And find nothing? Okay. Professor
Wumo.com, right? Yeah. That's what I do, is I scream my website URL as I'm digging.
At the bird.
That's what I would do.
Okay.
Wait, where is it digging to, though? Because there's no ground. Because we're flying.
I think I'm going to go into the hallway.
And everyone's going to be in there wrestling over a parachute.
And you're over there just like...
And Brandon's just running directly away as fast as possible.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Brandon gets no fucks. He's going to go live with the bird.
I do.
Greg does?
And Greg does.
All right. Can I have dice for the roll?
5.
How many?
5.
If this bird is smart enough to find you in this massive
mansion. Knowledge?
Yeah, he's making it.
I have 4.
You rolled a 4.
I need one more die.
Hi!
What is your dog doing?
He's just under the table.
I got
she
5.
She succeeded.
Son of a bitch.
She left?
No. She
I
succeeded
keep
in
it.
Keeping the parachute.
Oh, he tried
again.
To take
Flash's
it.
Flash's turn. I move here, and I jump.
Oh, you can jump through the collapse room. Duh.
I make a, knowledge of 3. I need to roll 4, right?
Yeah.
I fail. I don't go anywhere.
Because you don't have enough knowledge.
I don't have enough knowledge. I'm
stupid.
So you get there and then you're just like, shit, I don't know anything.
How do I do a parachute? How do
what happens when I do that?
What did you just do?
I just jumped.
With the knowledge of 4, she made it.
You're gone.
I win. So you're one of the winners.
Hang on.
But I won first.
Hang on, I gotta read something.
We gotta read this.
So if you win.
Wait, so you're telling me that the person to exit the house successfully wins the game?
Yes.
But there's one more person that
can win. And yet you cannot choose to immediately exit.
You have to have the
You have to make it and live.
The air rushes past you like a hurricane. With a flood of relief, you feel that your parachute open above you and you fall slow. Then you hear a flapping noise. Looking up, you see some tears in the fabric of the chute. A few of the ropes seem tangled, too. Perhaps the chute got damaged in all the fighting, but for now it seems to be okay. The tears don't seem to be getting any bigger. Not yet, anyway.
Can I speak
what
to...
What the shit?
Can I speak
don't
to this character?
Can we keep going?
No, you're done. You're out.
Can I speak to this character?
Can I won?
No.
Okay,
what character?
You're still at an advantage. You're still probably going to survive. There have been people that have free-fallen and survived from very high up.
So you want to take your chances.
If you just try to reduce your terminal velocity by getting big...
Already there.
And then I mean
squirrel it.
It's gonna be bad. No matter what happens, it's gonna hurt a lot.
See, that I think's fun though.
If you got a cell phone, go ahead and call 911. It's a good time.
Good time to do that.
I mean you don't have any other time.
It's
your turn,
Micah. It's gonna be
it's
a minute though. Like minute.
You have the only other parachute.
I do.
So hi.
You have a lot of time.
So is there something that happens when I go into that room?
You can make your terminal velocity pretty low, like 60 miles an hour. You've got a whole minute.
Okay, hi.
Hello.
Depends on
I'm
how
going to fight you.
With altitude.
I'm sure.
With knowledge.
What is our altitude? Is that why you asked
us? Does anyone have an altimeter?
God damn.
Hey, yeah. Which one?
Brandon.
Can you get out of there?
Cthulhu.
All right. Brandon's probably got one of those really tacky watches with an altimeter.
Okay, Brandon, it's your turn.
He probably does.
Yeah.
He did promise a good time.
Are you sure?
Oh,
I think.
God.
No, anyway.
Okay. Well, I'm going to continue moving. Room me.
But why?
But why?
Abandon
the
room.
With an omen card.
Cool. Love omens.
He's the only thing that's happening in this game right now. All of us are being boring.
Medallion. Well, because honestly, if really winning the game is just whoever exits the house safely, I would have just done that immediately. But clearly this game, you know, we're really picking, we're seeing some flaws here. Okay.
Obviously.
There's a medallion inscribed with a pentagram.
Oh, dear.
You're immune to the effects of the pentagram, chamber, crypt, and graveyard. Good enough. And I now need to make a haunt roll.
You don't
We
have
don't
to.
Have that anymore.
Well, if
the
we discover the graveyard, we will.
If we discover the graveyard.
The pentagram chamber.
That's for you. That's actually, I think, a basement room.
I don't know.
Anyway.
The crypt?
You can find that one.
I want a crypt.
You want a crypt?
I want a crypt.
I know there's a graveyard on the ground floor.
I think crypts are, like, definitely in the basement. Like, you can't have a high crypt.
Well, the ground floor can have a graveyard, so...
I mean, you could have a high crypt, it just wouldn't be a room.
The definition of a crypt. Yeah. Well, I'm sorry.
Anyway. AJ?
Tomatoes.
Professor Longfellow.
Oh my goodness.
It's your turn. Would you also like to come fight me for my parachute?
See, the thing is, I think I'm actually going to lose if I do that, so I might go explore a little bit.
Okay.
No, I'm going to go try to fight you for a parachute.
Okay.
I was going to say, you'd be a little late.
In the game? You've already explored most of the house.
I would really love is if you are off exploring and you come back and kill us all,
with
and then you still win.
I'm probably not going to do that.
I'm assuming you're making a knowledge.
I really just want to keep going, obviously.
You just want to look at the house.
Yeah.
There you go.
Look, pretty things.
You know,
shiny.
We're going to die. Might as well explore.
Oh, damn it. He gets the parachute.
Yay! So that's the end of that
Can
turn.
You get the parachute and then choose not to use it?
Well,
I mean,
his turn's over. Now it's my turn, and now I gotta try and get this back?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, fuck this. I'm killing Professor Longfellow.
No.
Yeah. No, I'm attacking you. I'm attacking
you. If you attack him, what happens to the parachute when he dies?
I get the parachute.
You get the parachute? Okay.
But the parachute actually drops.
Bullshit.
He leaves it there.
It's just in the
what? Room. No! Before you kill me,
says that I'm Craigslist.
What if I ration with you just a little bit?
You give me the parachute and then die anyway. I don't.
No. Here's.
Are we gonna jump together?
It's a parachute.
Here's the thing. I'll never let you go, Jack. So.
All right. Well, I wear
the parachute. Why don't you share the door? Why don't you share the door with me?
You co-use it and you both die.
Share the door with you.
Yes. like in Titanic. We're gonna show the door.
Now that I'm done.
Right. So I wear the parachute.
I hold on to you.
And you hold on to me.
Yeah, you're like, what do I do now?
The rules don't say that we can't do that.
Tumblr.
The
rules do not say that we can't do that. We decided to coexist.
There you go. Wait, so if the rules don't say that you can't do something, you can do it?
No. No. We're bullshitting now.
Yes, he's gonna kill me.
I'm gonna kill him.
Death is coming. Maybe?
No, he only takes 1 point of damage.
So he's alive. Yeah?
Wait, how? Well, I rolled a 5.
And you rolled a 4.
My might is a 1.
Oh, you can only roll one die. Did you only roll that?
Yeah.
Oh, you take 5 then. You're dead.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, so...
Dead.
Well, that sucks.
Why did you put it in? Oh, it drops.
It drops.
Well, your turn's over.
My turn is over. Once you pick up the chute, your turn's over.
God damn it. Okay, well... I'm gonna leave it then.
Using the normal rules, the dead hero carrying a parachute drops it, and hang on before you answer.
Yes.
Any other hero can pick it up. Heroes stole each other's, they were monsters, it doesn't say anything about, actually it doesn't slow you.
Then I'm going to pick it up and try to jump.
Okay.
Wait.
Wait, what?
What?
So I couldn't have stole it and then jumped, though.
Mm-mm.
But you can pick it up and try
you
to
can
jump.
Pick it up and jump.
Bullshit.
Okay, I'm going to
fuck
try
this bird
to,
in
okay,
the
it's
house.
With your knowledge or your sanity. Yeah?
Knowledge or sanity, yeah.
I'm going to try and psych myself up. So 4. And I have to roll 4?
Yes.
Well, that fucked.
So, slash flex. And it's actually Brandon's turn.
You got all that bravado.
So by psych slash yourself flex. Up, you mean that you can roll to increase a specific stat?
No.
So you either have to know what you're doing, so knowledge...
Or you have to be optimistic enough to just...
Optimistic enough to just go. Yeah.
I'm just saying, Brandon
has
enough speed.
If you're insane, you can't... You won't jump because you'd be paranoid. If you're sane, then you can psych yourself up.
If you're sane, you would have left the house.
Brandon, I'm just going to let you know, you have enough to go back and steal the parachute and jump.
I'm not interested.
Where would you like to go?
I'm gonna continue to go this way.
Okay.
Just
way,
like
I
a kid.
I want to get up there. Then we can go that way.
God damn, all of the fucking basement tiles.
The organ room.
Ah, yes.
Nice.
That's good.
Haunting melody. Event card.
For you. You can play.
Disquieting sounds. Well, it's from the organ. A baby's cry, lost and abandoned.
That's not from the organ.
A scream.
Well, it might be.
The crack of breaking glass, then silence. Now, can I choose to be uninterested in this?
No.
That's silly.
Because I'm not.
Roll 6 cubes. If you roll equal to or more than the number of omens that have been revealed, you gain 1 sanity. If
Fair.
Not, then take 1 die of mental damage.
How
many
I understand. Die, it's not that you instantly die. It's that you... have to use a cube.
So, wait a second. What are you interested in, then? If you're not interested in, first of all, surviving this parachute
okay,
jump.
You hear disquieting sounds, and think about... You just keep going. Right. Like, that's the... You know, like,
you just keep going, what's this?
You know? I'm gonna freaking dig in the floor.
And get nothing.
Well, you failed. You take whatever damage or something.
One... So I have to roll.
Okay.
1 die worth of sanity damage?
1 die with a mental damage.
Which is your sanity.
Okay.
What'd you get?
2.
Nice.
So, now,
you can divide between knowledge and sanity, or you can put it on one or the
other.
Those
are all mental. Your knowledge and your sanity are mental damage spots.
These aren't incremental?
No, they're sectional. So, like, 1, 2. So your stat doesn't always go down a die if you lose some of your sanity.
Because sometimes, like for me, my 4 range is more vigilant.
So the increment in itself is a stat.
Yes.
Yes.
That's actually pretty ingenious. So
the one compliment the game has received.
No. So can I go down? So I can just literally just move down 2.
Yes. To 3.
To 3.
Yes.
That's fascinating.
Mm-hmm.
I see why Cooper likes this 2 game stuff.
Compliments.
This game.
I see why Cooper likes this game stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Hmm. I see.
Alright. It
okay,
is now
Terry.
My turn. I'm gonna mite you, and I'm gonna actually try and kill you.
Okay, let's go.
So I roll 5.
I need 4.
Try to kill her with knowledge.
So you have to roll 5.
Knowledge is power.
Or
yeah,
speed.
I do.
There you go.
I hit you with 2.
And I'm going to attack with...
You block
3.
All
3! Doesn't hit go back you? To
me? Sure, why not?
I think.
We'll go with that.
Kill him, Micah.
So I hit him with one.
Okay.
Okay.
So your might goes down to...
Or my speed. Because it's physical damage.
It's physical damage.
So I would like to go to the restroom.
Okay, so... Now that I have the parachute still... That one tried to kill me. I'm gonna try to jump with my sanity again.
Fail.
I failed again.
Brandon!
Nope.
Brandon, you little
Brandon!
Shit.
It's your turn, you little shit!
Maybe I should have run
maybe
to the front door.
Probably.
I'm a dumbass. So while we're waiting on that guy back there, recycle? I'm going to...
You guys should recycle.
We have a recycling bin.
Is that what this is?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
But we just throw it away anyway.
Wow, then what's the point of the recycling bin?
I slaved over all this food for you guys not to eat it.
I will totally munch on that all night.
I know you
will. One right now. I'm going to do it up, though.
The more that people don't eat, the more that I have to eat later.
How does this work?
I want to lick your face.
What the fuck?
No, you don't have to wait for it.
Wait, it's
timer.
Super slow.
So,
now just
wait. I need you to run that one by me again real quick.
Oh, then we need to get back to position one and two.
Back
to where we were. We need to rewind.
Rewind.
All right, so.
This is why we shouldn't leave you two alone on the cam.
I want to lick your face.
Okay. Wait, what?
Makes for interesting content.
I mean, fine.
Oh, perfect! Tastes like shame. Probably because you killed
shame.
Me.
How that ran.
Do you remember when you killed me?
Alright, anyway. So, David, it is your turn. Would you like to explore the next room? Next room? Hey, look, this is the graveyard!
Hey, look, it's that room that you were talking
well,
about!
Well, I've got that goddamn omen, so we're good.
Wait. Is this an outdoor graveyard or an indoor graveyard?
Apparently it's an indoor graveyard.
I want an indoor graveyard.
That is terrifying. Would
and
you need, like, AstroTurf?
Yes. Revolving wall.
Oh, God.
The wall spins to another place.
Great.
That's very vague. I mean, like...
You get a revolving door.
What is spinning the wall? Is it pneumatic, hydraulic, electric?
That's a great question.
Is it steam-powered, maybe?
A steam-powered wall?
Maybe it's just...
That would be cool.
You know, a clever use of potential energy. Here.
Other one?
Place the wall switch token on a wall without
a wall
in
switch.
This room.
Oh, okay.
It's a wall
or
switch.
Or a corner of this room. Wait. This is a graveyard. This is not a room. If there isn't a room on the other side of the wall switch...
It's an indoor graveyard.
This is... Draw room tiles until you find one. If there are no more rooms on this floor, discard this card...
I'm so confused.
What secret room did we move into?
The chapel.
That's actually...
I like that, I can do that.
Maybe you should look at this card, because that, I'm already lost.
That's fair.
Oh, you need to make a check.
What am I checking?
Knowledge roll.
Whether you can open the door.
Yep.
I thought it was already revolving when I walked in.
No.
He's gonna make a joke.
The explorer finds... Okay. Once during an explorer's turn, if that explorer is in either room, he or she can attempt a knowledge roll to use the wall switch. That explorer finds the hidden switch and goes through. This doesn't count as moving a space. That explorer can't find the hidden switch and can't go through.
Honestly, Brandon's not checking every room's wall for a hidden switch.
Okay.
That'd take a long time.
We should.
We're moving on to me trying to kill Micah again.
Wait, so I'm just staying in the graveyard?
Sure, why not?
Cool.
You had to draw a card, so your turn.
Okay, over. What are you attracting the world
to? Might, because it's my only thing that I can kill you with. So there is a pretty decent roll. That
oh, I'm
was,
sorry.
That was a...
Was that a one?
That was a six total.
Okay. Six.
I'll believe you.
Well...
So you take five.
And I'm dead.
No, you're not. Divided between the might
oh,
and
that's
speed.
Right, you're right.
I'm gonna periscope this.
Wait, I could have done that, couldn't I?
Yes, divided it between things.
I still would have died.
Yeah, you still would have died. I would hit you. I hit you really hard.
I blocked none, and you hit me with five.
Yeah,
that's
well. I'm on my lowest one on both of my physical damages.
But you, if you manage,
but
to escape,
I live.
You do live, and you can still escape because it's your turn.
Okay.
You can escape while damaged. I'm just like, Madman, attack her, and he's just like,
what's this game called?
This game is called Betrayal at House on the Hill.
So did you kill her?
No, she's still alive,
I live.
But barely. She's twitching.
Did you steal the parachute at least?
No, I just punched her really hard.
Oh, so she can just go now.
Yeah, I'm just trying to kill her at this point.
I'm going to the front door, and then I'm going to try to jump again with my sanity and psych myself up. Well, there's one. I made it.
She makes it.
And
now we get to the other part. So, same thing as hers. You win. Good job.
But you might not win.
If you lose, that's AKA... Why are you recording again? That's David and I. Your so-called friends have left you to be food for the chick of this demonic bird of prey. Yep. On the other hand, maybe if you landed on another human body, you'd survive the fall. Your friend over there looks pretty soft.
That's actually... Now, I just want to check this real quick.
Yes.
Hello, Periscope viewers.
Periscope!
So what we're presented with a challenge here. It's huge bird carrying this house that we're in.
Two people have escaped. Like
yeah, and we're talking about using another player as a cushion.
Mm-hmm.
For the landing.
But I just want to say, if you are actually in free fall, that would be detrimental. Your best bet, just discard the player. Best bet, try to reduce your...
Terminal velocity.
Yes, we talked about this.
There are very few people that could spot me on that, so I appreciate you.
You're welcome.
By spreading out your hand, making yourself as big as possible, increasing your drag,
and then landing in what?
Well, can you choose that? I don't know. I mean, if you're experienced with, I guess in the last like.
I don't recommend water.
No, because if you fall from 80 feet. It's like landing on concrete.
It's not like GTA 5 where if you land in water, you live.
There are people that have survived free-falling.
Done that.
There are. That's true. That is true.
Do you want to survive, though? I don't know.
Because I'm pretty sure you...
Jesus, man, what's going on with your hair?
Jump out of the plane from the
highest point. It sucks, dude. It's speaking to me. It's yelling. It really sucks.
Into water.
Hey, continue the game. I'm sorry.
No, the game's over.
Game's over.
The main thing that I want to know...
We won.
They won.
Girls won.
I'm still stuck on the bird.
I want to say that I actually won because my immediate reaction to we've entered this house is I'd like to leave.
Get me the fuck out.
And that was before the
also,
bird.
Also, you took the high road and you didn't attack anyone.
It's true.
We all like got at each other's throats like fucking demons.
So Brandon's dead.
Brandon and I, you and I are, everyone, us three,
Brandon.
We're dead.
Honestly,
I've been dead for a while.
I mean, we might be dead too, for all that we know.
Apparently, the parachutes may or may not have been.
They may or may not have been functional. They had holes in them.
And this is an old house.
Okay, can we get back to this bird situation?
We don't need to get back to this bird.
No.
David.
I'm going to tell you why we need to get back to the bird situation.
Please.
And we're going to get to this.
Continue.
This bird is the size of what, a 747?
747.
Birds have hollow bones, right?
Right.
Yes.
Wouldn't you think that the weight of this bird and its hollow bones?
Before the bird actually came and got in the house, it died. Because it couldn't exist.
Yes. Wouldn't it just kind of fold under
African
its own
swallow.
Weight? This is a question I pose to everyone out there. Would this bird fold under its own weight? I don't know.
Sorry.
Like I was saying earlier, I don't know where National Geographic is in this because we should have known this before going into the house that this was native to this land was giant birds.
All of that
eat houses.
Yeah. It's a monster.
By the way, gigantic birds.
By the way,
we probably wouldn't have left.
Yeah, they're like, by the way,
we wouldn't have gone exploring.
We do have giant birds in this area. They're like bears, just don't feed them.
Just don't feed them.
Yes, Atlas, you're grumpy. All right. You're grumpy and you want to see.
There are four people watching this right now.
Wow. Really? Hello.
Hi,
and welcome.
People. Hello, and welcome.
Are we playing again? Are we?
Do you want to play again?
Are we playing again?
Do we have time to play again?
Well, I have time.
I'm down.
That was an hour-long game.
You can go, Greg. But I am totally down for another game.
I'll play again.
Because we only need a max of three players.
I know exactly what my first move is going to be.
You mean a minimum?
What's that?
Leading out.
Minimum.
You can't.
What?
You specifically cannot. Once you enter this room, the door locks behind us. Or enter the house, the door locks behind us.
You're gonna leave the house?
So all that energy that I would have devoted to figuring out how to open the door then. Because, okay, the door locks.
Also, you bent my cards, you piece of shit.
Well, that was fast.
Sorry.
You bent my card.
I'm not good at the game.
You bent my card, man. It's fine. They're durable.
Now that we get it, would this game go faster?
Yes, it would. Also, we wouldn't be doing this weird... I don't think that it was a very good haunt, personally, because we were already really close to each other. And we just...
It was too early for that kind of haunt.
It was way too early for that kind of haunt. Like, no one had weapons. It didn't go fast after that because it just happened too early. It's my bad. I rolled real low. I apologize profusely. Here we go again. Would you mind shuffling that?
When you said earlier that there's a traitor...
Oh, yes. That's nice.
Not all of haunts will have a traitor, but... I want one that does. I want one of us to be evil.
It's me.
So, I mean, technically, I killed a man.
It's me.
I don't have to be Brandon again, do I?
No, you can be.
I'll be the girl.
You can be whoever you want.
If it makes any sense,
I think we should just.
You did kill the man that had the most nefarious purposes.
I did. You were the one that wanted to play with the children.
Well, no,
the child. Sorry, child. I'm sorry. I apologize. He contacted you on Craigslist.
Holy shit!
That's not part of the game.
It was part of the game, though.
Yeah, it was. It said on his little card. Okay, so
then I would have sold the parachute on Craigslist.
Oh, my.
So you had a phone this entire time?
You had a phone this whole time?
What the fuck were you doing with it, you piece of shit?
The game did not specify whether or not we had a phone.
So we're magically just giving ourselves phones.
Yeah.
Can we do that?
I don't know.
The game doesn't specify.
How about we do
the game
this?
For the goddamn
card.
Greg is going to watch Lost and go to bed.
Okay, goodbye. No, the that card.
Oh, our other player?
I actually think I should.
Is anybody going to play some different characters?
We're going to random.
Don't worry, you'll be able to catch up.
We're
going to
random.
Random?
We're randoming.
Randoming characters.
That sounds fun, though.
Are you going to play?
We're randoming characters.
I'll play one more, fine.
All right, we're randoming characters.
Can we just go as fast as possible?
We can try.
Yeah.
Fast and loose.
No shenanigans.
No birds.
No birds. Preferably, no birds.
Hopefully, no birds. What if we get the same one again, though?
We will not. It's the chances are so unlikely. There's 50 different haunts.
Yeah.
That'd be really funny if we did, though.
It'd be really funny, and I'd be like, no.
This fucking bird! That's what we would do.
Leave us alone, bird!
God damn it!
Alright, so fucking how we're gonna do this rando thing is I need David or someone to hand me an article of clothing I can put over the
sweater.
Cards.
Oh, sweater! Yeah!
All right.
Again.
Way to go, Greg!
We're gonna do the rando.
Way to go, Greg!
Alright. Greg, you can go first.
So, I'm just going to leave the door open. I think
you're the first winner.
I was going to say, we... Cooling.
Would you just pick one? Dear God. Choices are awful for you. Okay.
Oh, I get the little boy.
So
you can pick either one of the ones.
I get to pick either one, right?
Card.
Don't pick Brandon.
You kind of let everybody down.
Yeah. Zostra.
I don't want...
Hey, Tuff.
This will be gender appropriation.
I kind of like Brandon. Me. So that's the difference. She's
playing a little boy.
Okay, there are cards. That's good.
This is a good thing.
I'll be Pita.
That's not my penis under there.
Pita?
Are you playing a man?
Darren!
Yes,
or
Darren.
Ox Bellows.
Darren has lots of speed, no knowledge,
he's
no sanity.
He's the speed guy, but he's an idiot, remember?
Ox Bellows.
That's why he lost and died.
I'm
gonna be Darren.
Darren
Speed.
Fast and loose. Darren Flash Williams.
Did you say fast and loose?
Fast and loose.
You don't need strength. You don't need strength in life.
All
right. I'm playing the priest. Fuck it.
I have a need.
Isn't there
for
a six
speed?
Huh?
Oh. Where's the slider?
Poor little Zoe.
Yeah.
We need
got left out again.
Again?
Poor little Zoe.
No one wants to play the little girl.
I think I'll stick with Heather.
Heather seems like a cool chick.
Thank you, Greg, for your
Heather, the little 18-year-old.
My cardigan.
Like,
cardigan's her life.
She's the shopping bitch, isn't she?
The shopping bitch?
Oops.
Yeah, she's 18. She likes television and shopping. Like most 18-year-olds.
Oh my god, how generation...
Can I just talk like her the entire game?
Yes, in character.
Please,
go.
Please, Valley girl.
We're all going in character, go.
If I am Madam Zostra, then I am clearly rough.
I'm gonna be really annoying, little boy. I'm Peter.
I'm Darren.
Do you want to do another sync, though? My friend.
No, there's no point.
There's no point.
So, like, oh my god,
sure?
My dad, like, totally put me on
are
the
couch. Are we doing this more on a Periscope basis?
Go clap. I'll clap, David.
My phone has battery.
Clap
so.
For me, David. That sounded weird. Never mind.
I like that your mobile mic actually survived that whole recording, though.
It did. Well, we gave it new batteries.
No, we didn't.
Yeah,
the batteries are still there.
Oh, did we not put... Oh.
We have not used the batteries.
Shiza!
There we go.
Can we please call it Drycast Gamecast?
No!
Drycast Gamecast.
Why call it Drycast when we can call it Tabletop 6?
I thought we were just playing If You're Happy, You Know, Clap Your Hands.
No.
If you're happy, you
so
know.
So sorry.
Where's my dog?
Nothing to be gained
Atlas?
From that game.
He's right there.
Okay. Because, like, the door's open, so it's just like,
he's not going to run if
he
we're all
died.
Right here.
It's true. How many times have you done that?
Right. Okay,
but would you still mind? Would you please take that and set that in front of the door so we at least have some kind of notification?
No.
If he tries to get out.
I feel like we'll have
plenty when we see a dog run that way. That's just
I don't need those.
No, I need sweatshirt.
You were
what I've already got. Because it is weather.
If you see an animal leaping out of the corner of your eye,
please notify me immediately, as I must go retrieve my son and dog.
You're very much going to be able to notify us.
And it's pretty cold out there, so that means the bugs won't be swarming us, which is nice.
Yeah, no, this is pretty sweet.
I went to the Pinnacles the other day, and there were still bugs. It was sad.
So many bugs.
I'm trying really hard. This is hard to shuffle.
So, I'll take half, you take half.
Oh, are we going in reverse this time?
On the table.
Okay, that works.
My birthday is June 6th, D-Day.
D-Day.
That is relevant because
this is D-Day.
No, well, lots of people died on D-Day, and what could they have done to survive? Gone faster.
There you go.
That sounds horrible.
I have Heather Granville.
All right.
The likelihood that a World War II survivor, who is the only legitimate trigger candidate for that, is watching this.
I apologize for him.
Wholeheartedly.
What, there's like two left?
Maybe.
I think there's very few.
We're in like double digits at least.
Well, we're getting to the point where like almost all the Holocaust survivors are dead too.
Yeah.
We're close to that.
I mean, that's a different trigger.
Wait, what are you doing?
That was pretty far
Terry,
away.
It's backwards.
Oopsies.
Have you guys ever had the pleasure of meeting a Holocaust survivor?
I have.
It's very interesting.
I have. My grandfather died in the Holocaust.
My great-grandpa was.
But why would you bring it up, then?
Fell off the guard tower.
Anyway.
I'm sorry, that's a horrible joke.
Did you say he fell off the guard tower? That is hilarious.
That's a joke that you should be making, given that you're the leader of the Fourth Reich.
I am.
Low-key.
Ich bin der Führer.
Low-key Hitler.
Ich bin der Führer.
Did you put your...
No, der Führer.
Oh, sorry.
You gotta get more phlegm in it.
Ice and Tice
for like... Ich bin ein Berliner.
The fuck?
Ich...
If you don't know what that's from, get out.
Anyway, so
it's from anyone who's from Berlin.
No, really? It is from a speech that JFK did during.
All right, so
I know I've heard it.
Yeah. Your birthday is August 2nd.
A Berliner.
My birthday is
for a donut.
April 29th. Also, she by the wins. Way, since we're, I think
I'm December 10th.
I'm the only one playing a new character. Yes.
Yes, I do believe. No, right. No one's playing a new... Yes, you are.
No one had Heather last time, did they?
No one played
Heather?
Wait.
I'm playing Zolstra, and she's playing Peter.
Right.
I'm playing
Peter. We're all playing... except for David.
Okay.
We're all playing David.
Well, then, here we go for character introductions. I'm playing Father Reinhardt. He is age 62. He's an old fuck. He's 5'9", weighs 185 pounds. His hobbies include fencing, gardening... Fencing and gardening. That's what this man does. He is a priest who is into fencing and gardening.
I mean, with that picture,
I really love that the atheist is like, playing the father.
Taking his meds.
I know, I do this every time. I'm the atheist, and I always play the religious figure. It's what I do. I find it entertaining.
It's very ironic.
We told you he's a Pastafarian, though.
He is a Pastafarian. Or, in this particular case, since it's me, a Cthulhu.
Can we move on?
A Cthulhu? Anyway, his birthday is April 29th. Moving on to you. Peter.
I am Peter Akimoto.
You're an Asian!
Apparently. I am 13.
Adopt Asian accent, go!
I don't know.
No!
No!
To all the Asian viewers out there, we apologize.
That's
adopt
not.
Adopt a.
I was gonna say, because there's too many Asian.
There's nothing to be gained.
Countries.
By that.
Everything's been gained.
There's
moving
nothing
on.
To
don't shoot me down all
so,
time.
Peter,
my hobbies are bugs and basketball. My birthday is September 3rd.
Bugs and basketball?
Bugs and basketball.
Yep.
Actually, I think technically hers is closer. Or are we talking like, closest forward?
Closest to forward.
Cool.
So, where are you at?
No one's
what?
What are you at?
I am playing
birthday-wise.
Zostra again, though.
Birthday-wise.
Okay. September
10th. December 10th.
December 3rd.
December 10th.
And that means, do you want to read your, because we didn't play with her last time, so go ahead.
Yeah.
Okay. I am playing with Heather Granville.
Of course she's a Heather.
She, is 18 years old. She's 5'2". I'm not going to tell you my weight.
Oh my God, Heather, bulimia is so 87.
There's no one watching, so I'm going to bait the stream again. Hang on.
Blech.
Bait it. I don't know why someone would want to watch.
I like television and shopping. My birthday is
August 2nd.
Ooh, Leo.
I think. No, what is that? What would that be?
Jack,
what?
Job.
What comes before Virgo? Is that Leo?
I don't really know.
When is Virgo?
I don't really know.
Wait, eight. Well, what's birthday?
Leo's like...
August 2nd.
August 2nd?
Leo.
It's Leo,
that's
right?
Leo.
Adam, that would be
Leo. So yeah. Leo.
September 3rd? Wait, what's the...
Anyway.
Yeah, astrology is part of my interests.
I would assume
it is,
so.
Actually. It's her hobby.
So, anyway, would you like to introduce yourself?
Oh, I'm Zostra again. We've played Zostra. Well,
astrology has a bit of a scientific basis, by the way.
A little bit. I agree with
it. Go first. Go.
Anyway.
Okay, anyway.
Wait, no, you don't need dice.
Just need dice.
Yet.
I'm going to explore. Yes.
Well, I mean...
You do
we could just hang out in this hallway.
We could.
I mean, that
nothing
is true.
Would happen.
I'm going to go this way, though, so bye.
But if we
see the hallway...
I'm going to have and they were stuck in a game for the rest of their lives.
Oh, look, I found the kitchen, guys. It's all fine.
Oh, look, it's an omen.
Oh, great, an omen card already.
Rolls all blanks.
Wow, real shocker, the woman found the kitchen. Ooh, too
guys,
soon.
Guys, you want to know what's better? I found
bad.
The kitchen.
I apologize.
And the first omen card is bite.
Oh, good, you got bit by something.
A growl, the scent of death, pain, darkness, gone. When you draw this card, something bites you. The player on your right rolls a might 4 attack against you for a mysterious something. Before it runs away into the darkness. You defend against the attack as normal by rolling dice equal to my own might. And then I keep the omen as a... I keep the bite as a scar of my battle.
Well!
Five.
That sucks.
Am I...
My might is 4, so let's go.
Well, there you go.
4.
You take 1.
I take 1 damage to a physical. We're gonna go with my might.
I'm correct to assume that if we do go through the kitchen, we don't have to...
We do not do the omen again.
Okay.
No, the omen has been activated. Once a room exists, the item is gone.
David?
I would just like to say that kitchen is hideous.
David, it is your turn. Would you like me to hold your camera?
No.
You, like, love dropping the dice.
I like holding them, too. And then I drop them. And then I pick them up.
Take it easy,
and then I drop them.
Wait, so I'm just choosing to... What do you think I'm...
You are moving.
Where would you like
where
to
where are you going?
Move.
Just
migrate.
Start grabbing a card.
Where are you going? Where are you going? What you doing?
That's
what are
you
doing? You're the red.
Quick.
You're not Brandon anymore.
Quick
how
down.
Far are you going?
Here.
Here.
One.
Here.
He's going
conservatory.
One
yes.
Again.
The event.
What's the event card you got?
Disquieting sounds. Can I just...
Do you want a different
again?
One?
Again?
Yes. Because
we've already had
my answer to disquieting sounds is... Ooh.
I don't care.
What's bloody vision.
Bloody vision.
Give me that.
Yes.
Wait.
I shuffled these.
I was going to say, it's so boring.
I didn't shuffle those.
I shuffled them.
Yeah, it's poor job, I guess.
Probably not.
I didn't think anyone had bloody vision. We had bloody vision
she
when
had
we played.
That was her first one, was bloody vision. Yeah.
Yeah.
That
nothing
doesn't
happened,
randomize
right?
Very much right there.
It's really hard to shuffle these without damaging them. I don't like bending the cards. It makes me
bend all of them. Break
ladies,
them. Half
you
them
both
in half.
Fine.
Someone came in for a second and then saw this and then left immediately.
And
good.
Then,
what is this
thing that you're doing?
No, I just kind of like periscoping and I have a phone.
I don't know
what exactly is that.
Periscope is like live vlogging.
It's a live stream.
A lot of celebrities
it's like
are doing it right
really,
now.
Really, really quick streaming.
Ah.
So it's not really a useful.
There you go.
And it's not reporting, is it? It's just.
But
like,
it functions.
Oh,
it's via app. Periscope's an app, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
That's what's nice
this.
About it.
Yeah.
Should we just periscope everything we do?
No.
Oh, dear God.
Actually, yes.
No one will watch.
No.
Okay, wait. Night view. You see a vision of
that was
a ghostly couple walking the grounds, silently strolling in their wedding best. You must attempt a knowledge roll. Is this a test of knowledge?
Yeah, apparently.
Apparently. You're an idiot.
I'm not interested.
Enjoy. Nope.
You have
do it.
To.
You recognize the ghosts as former inhabitants of the house. You call their names, and they turn to you, whispering dark secrets of the house. Gain 1 knowledge.
But only if you succeed.
I like this couple.
How do you recognize
I love their dark secrets?
The
that's 5 plus.
Well, we're from this town.
Okay, so with 3,
really?
You have to get 5
the
or more.
0 to 4, you pull back in horror, unable to watch. I hate playing characters. I wish I could just play me.
Well, then it'd be really boring.
Yes, it would. Because I would have left.
Okay, well, you succeed.
So,
you roll a 5.
You succeed.
So I'm
so
like,
guy.
And they're like, yo, you came to our wedding.
No, they turn around and they're just like. And then, yeah, you're just like, all right.
So you gain 1 knowledge,
okay.
Yes? Is that what it said?
Yes.
Very nice. Very nice.
Yes, and I'm at 4.
So they give you secrets.
Yeah,
the
you're
house,
not
right?
stupid anymore. No, you weren't stupid.
Yeah, still kind of stupid.
I mainly chose this because at least he has a stat that's a little bit above. Like, Brandon was just average. It was all 3 and 4.
And then he was really fast.
Heather, it's your Darren's just fast. Turn.
Are there any speed upgrades?
Heather.
So which one is Heather? This one's Heather, right?
That one's Heather.
So she's gonna speed up 4. It's gonna go in here, and then I'm gonna go here.
Clearly, Heather speaks to herself.
Dining room.
Well, yeah.
No one else here is smart enough to talk to her.
Okay, have those cards been shuffled?
Yeah.
All right.
Well, there's a limited amount of ground floor.
Okay.
So since we've already played the ground floor.
Holy symbol, a symbol of calm and unsettling world. Gain 2 sanity now. Lose 2 sanity if you lose the holy symbol. Make a haunt roll now. So I gain 2 sanity.
Okay, how many?
Holy symbol.
How many omens are on the table right now?
1.
2.
Where else would you hear that? How many omens are on the table right now?
All of them.
Alright, so I just have to roll above a 2.
Yeah, with some omens.
Good job.
Thank God.
Now I'm going to ruin everything and roll a 2 on a third omen.
You would. You would.
I intend to. Speed of 3.
I keep grabbing this
bag.
I'm putting it here. Because that's
easy. I found the fucking elevator.
You found the elevator again?
I found the elevator again.
Still don't know the carrying capacity.
No, we don't. They tell us the character
weight.
What
the fuck?
And I go to any floor.
Where you can go.
Up.
Does the character
weight
have to do anything with the game?
Only the upper floor. And I move
into eternity. Continue on up.
And I have a speed of 3, so I'm there. I am. I don't have to. You guys don't have to worry about me making the haunt roll.
So you're done.
Look at that. There you are.
What?
Go, Greg.
Greg!
You gotta
move.
Move. Move.
Greg, move.
You wanna
move? Move, Greg.
Stop playing with the dice and move.
I'm gonna go there.
What's your speed?
4.
Four. Nice.
So do I...
1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, she can.
Upper or ground, so there you go. Charred room.
Look.
What does that mean?
An omen.
What does that mean?
Read it.
Mask. A sober mask to hide your intentions. Somber.
A sober mask.
Once during your turn, you can attempt a sanity roll to use your mask. 4+, you can put on or take off the mask. What's the mask do?
Make a other option. Put on or take off the mask. If you put on the mask, gain 2 knowledge and lose 2 sanity.
I don't know.
If you take off the mask, gain 2 sanity and lose 2 knowledge. You can't use the
honestly,
mask.
Honestly, if I was just walking around a haunted
house,
I wouldn't
pick anything
up. So
you can put it on.
You just hang on.
I would stay close to all of my friends.
You roll 6 dice, and if you roll 3 or less, you trigger the haunt.
I would have left.
Or if you roll 2 or less.
Would have left. Time ago.
Good job. No haunt this time.
Thank God.
On the third omen. Terry. Fucking asshole.
No haunt on the third omen.
Thank goodness.
First down and 20. I don't know what handache words mean, so I can... But it's just like first down. Third omen, gentlemen.
Third omen down, and we succeeded. We've moved.
I'm gonna
I should announce for
leave
football.
The kitchen.
It's a bold move. Cotton. See if it plays out.
See
if it plays out.
Hey, look.
We've got
shit. The fucking junk room again.
Sucks to suck.
I thought that's where the elevator was, or does it just move?
No, the elevator can go anywhere. It's like the Wonka Vader.
It's
graveyard. So you can you leave? Because that's what the Wonka Vader. That was really what defined
the Wonka Vader.
That's what made it relevant. Is that you could leave?
Yeah, and you could go anywhere.
So it wasn't really an elevator at all.
It's not really.
Hey guys!
It was just a vehicle.
Girl, companion, a girl trapped alone. You free her. Gain 1 sanity and 1 knowledge now.
Compatibility check.
If I lose custody of the girl, I lose the 1 sanity and 1 knowledge. This omen can't be dropped, traded, or stolen.
You own
By
this
the
girl?
Way, that means that we can trade items.
Mm-hmm.
We can trade girls?
We can trade people.
Whoa, that's ridiculous.
Slavery inevitably comes
this
up.
This game is ridiculous.
Whoa!
Hey, I trade you my holy symbol for your girl.
You can't trade the girl.
I can't trade the girl, but like she could trade her mask.
I'm not trading my holy symbol.
Yeah, you might want that.
I'm just gonna repeat compatibility check because I haven't said anything that clever in quite a while.
Sanity is now 5, so that's nice.
David, I believe it is.
I'm already using.
That's the pass. Yes. That's my turn.
That's David's turn.
Simply your turn.
Wait. Make a haunt
jargon.
Roll.
Oh, I do have to make a haunt roll.
Oh God,
he's correct.
Roll less than, or roll more than
1, 2, 3, 4.
More than 4.
Oh, good.
We're totally good. For now. Okay.
So,
David, it is your turn.
Just stop me when I'm moving too much here.
You can go four, right?
You can go six.
You can go six. You can go upstairs through these rooms and into a new room.
How do we indicate that there are different floors?
That takes you upstairs.
And then you'll see it's like...
Basement, you have to discover in the ground floor.
Like there, that's the upper level. You'll be over there.
Okay. Go upstairs.
Always go
three,
upstairs.
Three.
Four.
Four.
Ooh.
You go five, six. Six. Two more. Six.
Wait. Let me see. What are my options here?
Okay, so this is the entrance, technically. Well, so one of these has to be the entrance from the... Oh, no, it's the stairwell. Five. Never mind. I got it.
The master bedroom.
Hey! You're going to have sex on the couch, right?
Omen, again.
It's the no-sex couch.
Well, that is a bed.
No, I think that's really not what I would do in that situation. I think what I would do is leave the house. I found a spear. A weapon pulsing with power. Spears should not pulse.
Every single room.
It's a penis job.
Almost. Except the conservatory.
You roll two additional cubes. Ten. Maximum of eight. How many can you have?
Tapping?
Cubes?
Yes.
I don't know.
Could I roll a bucket full?
You can roll
up to eight.
There's only eight. So, okay. When making a might attack with this weapon, you can't use another weapon while you're using this one. Make a haunt roll now. But I can also choose not to use the weapon.
Correct.
You can just keep it in your pack.
That's my choice.
Two, three.
Not going to use non-violence?
No, just not interested.
Shit.
Well,
three,
the haunt triggers.
The haunt.
Fuck, okay, so it's
spear, I think that's bad.
In the master bedroom.
It can the haunt be good?
It's the spear in the master bedroom.
So the object, yeah.
Anyway.
The object is haunted?
Hidden traitor.
Sometimes.
Oh dear. Hidden traitor. We don't know who the traitor is.
Nobody knows who the traitor is?
Which means that none of us are the traitor. Oh.
Someone is the traitor.
How is that going to be indicated?
I will tell you.
Oh, do I have to get like a whole other set of cards?
Sometimes it has to do with like, well, like, okay, in other situations, it's like the player with the lowest sanity is the traitor. Things like that.
I hope the one with the highest speed is the traitor. The quickest one is the traitor.
How this works is...
I've never done this one.
It's kind of exciting, I know.
We're going Lil Wayne now.
One is the traitor. So whoever has one is the traitor. Two, three, four... Five. I just need those five. So how this works is...
Do you have any more dice in there?
No. So I flip all these over. And then we hand them out.
So you're telling me that I have no volition here because I could be just picked as the traitor.
Yes.
Correct. Okay, so how this works is you can know what yours is. However... You can't
know what everyone else is.
You can't know what anyone else is.
Do I gain anything from figuring out who is the traitor?
If you are, no. If you are the, well, we don't know. We haven't read
the thing yet. Well, you might.
So.
You might. Who knows?
If I'm remembering my Will Wheaton correctly, you can. This is really fun.
Sometimes. So, the traitor is the person who gets the one marked one. The traitor can reveal himself at any time. And then games the traitor rules, which are different and we'll get to that shit.
Or we can keep going.
Does it make me faster?
Or we can play bullshit until someone panics enough.
Speed upgrade.
Now, those of us that are not traitors cannot let anyone know that we're not the traitor because...
That diseliminates everything.
Yeah.
Process elimination. All
no, because you're sitting there trying to figure out if any of your
co-players
are traitors.
Otherwise the game would be pointless.
Traitors.
Correct.
Hey.
So... We'll start with you, Greg. Don't let me see.
But we can look at it ourselves.
You can look at it yourself. Just, you don't want anyone else to see. Okay?
Okay. Well.
She's the traitor.
What?
That was quick.
What's that even mean?
You know, we can play the psychological games, because if I remember correctly, again, from Tabletop, someone did say that, and then they went into a whole little tangent. And
about
like,
why they were the traitor?
Yeah, he was just saying that because he is the traitor, and let's not worry about that.
Oh, dear.
Okay, so.
The traitor is larger.
The star sickness. Next to the spear, you find a note that reads, "Ever since I touched that meteorite, I can feel the change working in me. I have studied it and looked at it under a microscope and have found a twisted DNA that never came from this world. But what is even worse is that I have heard the creature inside my blood talking to me, telling me how much better use they can make of my body than what I have done with it. I have sought an antidote serum, but I am out of time, and soon I will belong to the microbes entirely. Before that happens, if I can steel myself, I intend to run upon my spirit like the ancient Romans and hopefully eradicate the alien spores once and for all. If I do not succeed, perhaps these notes will help whoever comes after. I pray, though, that this disease will die with me. You will know it by three stages. At first, it feels like a particularly virulent fever, as your immune system fights against it. Uh-oh, you've been feeling stuffed up ever since you got here. In the second stage, the spores take over the host's mind. Can you trust all of your friends? And in the third stage,
no.
Horror.
When do they start talking?
Right now. Take a set of small monster tokens of the same color numbered from one up... numbered up from one up to the twice the number of explorers and mix them up. Each player takes two and then looks at them but doesn't show them to anyone. Whoever has the token number one...
So they're supposed to be 10.
I did this wrong.
So we were supposed to have, like, a lot more.
I apologize. I thought it was the same amount. That's my fault.
Wait, so we're reading...
Good, because I was a traitor.
Oh.
You got the one and you were like, fuck me.
I was just like, I have no idea what's going on. I'm just gonna let go.
Little Peter Akimoto went and touched a meteorite, guys.
God damn it, Peter!
Oh, so the traitor touched the rock.
The traitor touched the meteorite. That so writing through, was the traitor. But the thing is I think that it's possible that this is someone else who had the effects.
So, wait a second. The writer. What you're trying to tell me is this meteorite is like the ball in Space Jam?
Yes. Sure.
This is actually, much more feasible than a giant bird, because actually there are parasites that exist today on Earth. Check episode 44 of Drycast. We talked about that. That can influence your behavior. Is there anything more terrifying than acknowledging that, yes, there are parasites that people have right now that influence...
Well, cordyceps, I think is that's what you're talking about. They can't actually influence humans. They only do like bugs and stuff like that.
They could evolve though.
There's definitely a parasite.
There's that man in Florida that ate someone's face off.
I thought that's because he was on.
Oh yeah, no, I know that.
What is it? Bath salts.
Bath salts.
Why are you screaming in my ear?
Because bath salts.
Because bath salts.
Look, we don't have to. We can use proper English.
Proper
English. Because thing.
Drugs?
I don't English.
We could say just because bath salts instead of saying because. Not a demand, just a suggestion.
Suggestion?
Look.
You're right.
Pronunciation was not a part of that little talk I just gave.
No. Okay, so now we have 10 and everyone gets 2.
Correct.
You get 2.
And if they add up to 1...
Micah's or is it just one of them is going to
I
be
I haven't even looked at it yet.
Wait, what?
Micah's the traitor. Okay, so yeah, how does this work once we get all of them?
We'll get there in a second.
We all get two.
Mm-hmm.
These are spores.
Each player takes two and looks at them but does not show them to... Oh, I don't hand them out. I'm sorry.
Freaking damn it, Terry.
I'm fucking sorry, guys.
Just mix them up.
Just mix them up and then I'll set them down. Yeah.
Wow.
It's not quite so...
And then we go and like a hat.
Yes.
Do we have a hat?
Can we just make this super complicated? We can do a hat. Give me a hat.
Can you use your hands?
No one has a hat. Just like,
what
use your hands.
What difference is there between your hands and a hat?
You have a hat.
Don't use that hat.
Let's not make things complicated. All
right.
Just don't look.
Pick one. There it is. Why is this in the hat, though?
One?
Yeah, pick one and don't look.
What if...
Wait, when can I look?
Are we picking two?
I looked at it immediately. We can look at them.
Pick one?
We can't show them.
Yeah, don't show them.
Just pick one?
Yep, just pick one.
I was going to say, does it really matter when I look?
No, I guess not.
Okay, and then you need to take one. And then I'm going to take another one, right?
Mm-hmm.
Hold on, it rubs the lotion on the skin.
What? Is there only one left now?
That's the thing.
You didn't take one yet.
Well, I was rubbing lotion on my skin, that's the thing.
You're not allowed to.
It's Betrayal at House on the Hill.
Betrayal at House on the Hill.
Okay.
Homo.com.
Now.
Look at her hands up now.
I see that. But doesn't show... each player takes two and looks at them, but doesn't show them to anyone. Whoever has the token number one is the traitor. More traitors might appear as the haunt progresses.
What?
You remain a traitor even if you lose the token numbered one later on. If the research laboratory is not in the house, the haunt revealer searches the room stack for that tile and places it in a legal position, then shuffle the room stack.
So we need to look for the research lab.
So more people become traitors because of the spores and all that good
shit. Yep, seems that way.
So they develop over time. So we all are infected in some way, shape, or form, possibly.
We could all lose this game.
Sit rep.
Oh, dear.
We have a disease.
Is it operating laboratory?
It came from the sky.
Research laboratory. Oh, found research laboratory.
Can't you help us?
Upper or basement? So
we have an upper level. We don't have a basement.
Seeking medical attention. We can't roll for medical attention.
We cannot roll for medical
attention. I love how the research laboratory is off of the master bedroom.
Right.
Hey.
Coincidence?
Where else you gotta put it? Like,
so
airlock, straight into the lab.
Encountered.
Wake up, straight into the lab.
Disease of some sort on the earth. And it has taken us over.
Aliens.
Somewhere.
I don't know. Neil deGrasse Tyson.
Huh?
Why?
We have a special guest here today on...
Fucking aliens.
All right.
Anyway.
So there's a traitor. Wait.
Someone is infected and the aliens are telling him what to do with his... With their...
Yep. Can I say no?
Set aside a pile of
treasure. I don't think no means no to
these. I think it's in your brain.
Other one.
Oops. Oh, that was our train.
What we were taught in high school, I don't think applies to spores.
As well as pentagonal item tokens that represent the serum. Set aside a pile of.
Okay, so
what constitutes a pile?
There is one traitor, though, is there not?
Right now, there's
one. There's one. Multiple people could be infected. Like, over time. We don't know what the conditions
of that are. Do we have access to antibiotics?
Yes. Yes, we're getting there. In the research laboratory, there's possibly a serum. The person that wrote us this note developed a serum, but he was dead.
I was just making jokes, but that's cool.
Did he die, or is the person that wrote the note part of us?
I think it's not one of us. I think it's whoever owned the house.
I see.
Is what it sounds like.
Undrop that.
Did you drop another dice?
No, it was over the triangle.
So... We're all. We could be incrementally traitors.
Correct.
I don't see
which is much more realistic because, you know.
I see it.
You know, one day all of a sudden a traitor and it makes a popping noise?
Those are not traitors. Oh, these are
knowledge.
Is there only four?
Yeah.
Okay. So,
you got a good one, too.
If you're worried about any sleeper cell agents in your midst, listen for the popping. But no, really, being a traitor, it's a gray. Area. On a scale. A scale.
Okay.
It looks like this. So if you see Vladimir Putin and he's got one of those.
Oh wait, the scale card came out?
Yeah.
What?
Wait, it turns.
So is this the level of how fucked we are?
I don't know. I don't know how
that's how there long are lo- there are it takes for people to start turning. Oh, we're numbered 1 through 10.
There's 12.
Okay, so this haunt uses the hidden traitor rules described on the rulebook. You all read this booklet, but one of you is a traitor. The traitor has been infected with an alien virus and seeks to turn the rest of you into aliens. Anyone who holds the traitor token cannot reveal it at any time. You win when the heroes win when they have created the serum and all living explorers have been inoculated. If all the explorers are dead or have become traitors or aliens, the traitor or traitors win. If the traitors win, the person who became a traitor most recently loses instead.
I can't be bothered. I've already done this in way too many video games. I'm done with it.
Right, anyway.
I'm gonna sit in a corner and wait for him.
Of course, classic.
But you're the one that's closest to the research labs!
So how... Damn it.
Yes, you are.
Damn it,
what are you doing?
You're the one that triggered the haunt.
Oh so. Yeah, I guess. I'm not gonna take accountability.
This is your fault.
For what? For giving everyone you the must disease, do this, the nasty space AIDS?
Here's when fault. They have created the serum and so all living explorers have been inoculated. If all the explorers are dead or have become traitors,
I just
or aliens,
gone
the traitor
the house.
Then the traitor
exactly.
Or traitors win.
That's even
the
smarter.
Win,
like, personally, me, if I see, spooky win, house.
Cool. Sorry, I've got other stuff to do.
Right?
Yeah.
Like, I have, that
oh my
tooth
God,
doesn't even take that long. Just, I have other stuff to do. Probably don't even say anything, you know? It's internal monologue.
I mean, if it's a group of people, you kind of got to... Make it seem like it's something important.
Oh, I wouldn't do.
What time is your class?
Oh, just nope.
That's not bad.
You must do this on your turn. The first time each turn you occupy a room with another explorer, you must give each other one of your face down monster tokens chosen at random.
Well,
if there are multiple
already.
Other explorers in the room,
that's
exchange with only one.
Work.
He or she must be an explorer you have not previously exchanged with. If possible, you can make only one exchange during each of your turns.
Might trigger Ebola victims right now.
If you receive the token numbered 1 during one of these exchanges, you permanently become a trader, even if you trade away that token later. The Haunt Revealer must do this. At the end of his or her turn each round, it's you, by the way, David, advance the turn / damage track to the next number. Then roll a number of dice equal to the turn number. This is a physical attack using might against every explorer in the house. Each explorer resists the attack using might as normal. Traders are not immune to this attack.
I resist with speed.
The alien disease battles everyone's immune system. There is no upper limit to the number of dice for this attack.
Okay, so every time we hit your turn, it's another round of attacks from the virus.
Correct.
My turn.
Creating the serum.
Because you triggered it. So every time we come back to you, it's been one circle. And then the virus will attack us.
Once per turn, if you are in the research laboratory, you can attempt a knowledge roll of 5+, add one die to this roll for each other explorer in the room, and add an additional die if the book is present.
Well, god damn it. Flash is the one that's closest, and he's an idiot.
Yeah, I know. I was about to say that. Like, I feel like I should still rely on speed for this.
Okay. Wait, we don't have the fucking scientist this time.
I have a knowledge of 5.
I have a knowledge
of
4.
You have the best knowledge, probably. I have a 4. I'm pretty good.
Explorers can also search for herbs, to create the serum in the conservatory or the gardens. If these rooms are in the house, at the end of your turn in either of these rooms, you can attempt to make a knowledge roll of 3+. If the roll is successful, take a knowledge roll token.
Wow, you're talking really fast.
Representing the herbs. And place it on your character card. Treat this token as an item. It can be dropped, traded, or stolen. You can search for herbs each turn and carry more than one knowledge roll token at a time.
Herbs.
It is possible to collect more knowledge roll tokens than the number of players. Creating a serum requires collecting as many knowledge roll tokens in the research laboratory as the number of explorers, so 5.
5.
That
makes sense.
It's a lot of fucking rolls.
Yeah, this is a lot of crap. And then...
I'm not going to remember it anyway, nope. So...
We'll recap it as
I'm just
going
to keep moving away until someone tells me I can't.
Once you can do that, though. That's the thing.
That's the perfect unanimously rational response when there is a disease. You don't send 200,000 people toward the disease.
You escape disease.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you isolate
those
infected.
You've already been infected, though.
That was a reference.
Mm-hmm. Calling out
the U.S. government there.
A little bit.
Okay. This haunt, all explorers can attack each other. Huh? If a traitor dies for any reason other than being injected with the serum, that player announces that he or she is a traitor and that a transformation to the third stage is taking place. The transforming traitor skips his or her next turn. On that player's subsequent turn, the explorer becomes an alien. He or she drops any items, including nodule tokens. Aliens of speed 4, might 6, sanity 4.
So, Terry, not to burst your bubble or anything, but I think if we just start playing, nobody remembers anything that you said.
We'll have to recap.
Yeah, you can be the one responsible for making sure we don't screw up.
Yes.
Okay, it sounds to me like the main goal is to get the serum. Or the herbs.
Or leave.
Herbs.
Leaving is illegal. Well, the door locked.
By leave, I just meant keep running away.
That's also a thing. That is definitely a possible thing.
Am I trapped right now?
No, but we should probably go into the laboratory and try and...
But it's the end of his turn.
So whose turn?
So it's it's your turn.
So it's AJ's turn.
Or I could pass through the laboratory.
1, 2. This is 2, and then I go there.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can go to the conservatory that is down there and get herbs.
Herbs.
Why would I go to the research laboratory?
Or get
less knowledge.
No, the conservatory.
I have to go to the conservatory, not the research lab?
You can
either
go to
is
either.
Natural.
Okay. So 1, 2.
So you make a knowledge roll 4+, you get.
And there's an event first.
Oh, no, you don't get that.
No events?
No, you don't do that. That's already.
Only if the room is new.
So 4 die.
You don't have to do that. You can do
something. My knowledge roll is 5.
Oh.
Do people actually chill out in Periscope waiting for streams of games like this?
Maybe.
I don't know, maybe.
We have 4 viewers right now.
Wow.
Well, hi, guys. How are you?
Hello. And welcome to Betrayal.
How many times do I say what up all
well,
the time?
Well, I didn't make it.
I didn't know.
You are dumb.
He is not.
No. So what are we trying to do exactly? I'm a little lost.
Religion is of no help.
Okay,
what am I trying to do?
What we're trying to do right now is we're trying to make a serum so that we all don't die.
Yes.
That's the idea.
So you can either go to that research laboratory or to the conservatory or the garden for herbs.
So I could go to the research lab?
You could go over to that research lab, yeah.
And then I have to do a roll?
and you could do a knowledge roll to try and make the serum.
I could have made it.
Can I pass on my turn?
No.
Okay, because I could just pass for eternity, and then we never, the parasite would never increase.
Does it just, like, I roll once and I get the right amount?
If you get it wrong, then you have to distribute it to everyone in the house.
If I killed myself physically right now,
are you the traitor?
Until you can be in the same room as someone else and give the thing to them.
Did you have a one on either of those tokens? Well, don't answer that question.
If, I know. If this turn that, you went to the research lab, you if you had a one on one of those tokens, you're the traitor. Serum,
okay.
It would go through me. It would be the end of your turn. It would go through me and David. David would have his turn where we all get hurt by the thing. And then your next turn, you could go just administer it to David. But you have to administer it to everyone in the house, and you have to be in the same room.
And I'll be very far away. I can guarantee it.
Okay, well, it is now my turn.
So, David's gonna make sure we all die.
I don't want treatment because I've, this vaccine, it could
oh my gosh.
Give me
just
autism.
Just go.
And I'd rather be an alien.
Oh, was that a jab at Jim McCarthy?
No, not anyone
just
specific.
Just go.
It's your turn.
Is it?
Yes!
It's my turn.
Oh, it is your turn.
It's Terry's turn.
Again, hit up episode 44 of Drag Pass.
Any layers.
I missed you,
Terry. Is this optional?
Why did you do that?
This is required. Every time you occupy a room with someone, you have to do this.
The thing where you swap things.
Yeah, and then I'm going to go here.
Oh, we swap?
Yep.
Yeah, we...
So if you were already the traitor, you're still the traitor.
Yeah. Well, no. You could possibly swap the traitor token.
You can spread.
I thought if you were the traitor, one time, you're already still the traitor.
I am the traitor.
Wait, you revealing that you're the traitor?
I fucked up. I was the traitor, and now he's also there, too.
Who?
Me and him.
Oh.
The traitor can reveal at any point.
Yeah. Terry cannot keep secrets.
I'm sorry.
He found this out. He's very bad at this.
I'm very bad at secrets. Hello,
it's okay.
Everyone.
He can reveal it whenever he wants.
You're a traitor, too.
He better not. There's children present.
Yep.
So wait, you're in the research lab. Can you try to make the serum, or is your goal not to?
My goal is not to.
Have you read your traitor version?
Yes.
Good.
I suppose this is realistic, because
mean?
If you did have
what
the virus
right
and
now?
You were like,
I would try
yeah,
to, I would try and make him
yeah.
a traitor.
Sorry about that, but
well,
I kind of gave you a really viral
I just gave that guy.
Got it. Don't
the
go
aliens
there, then.
Have infected him enough that he's like, yeah, I'm going to kill everyone.
Yeah.
I just want to say that it's very unlikely that extraterrestrials would want to kill us.
Oh god, I'm done with this game.
Moving on.
Okay, so Terry, what are you going to do in the research labs?
I'm going to stand here.
He's going to Disney World!
You dick! You're baby guarding the fucking research labs. What a dick.
Wait,
anyway.
So I can't go in there?
You can go in there, but you're already infected.
So glad there's no big birds around this part.
Oh my gosh. Moving on.
Anyway.
I'm going, right?
Yes.
Do you need to go?
No, you're good.
Are you going back downstairs?
2, 3, 4. Yeah, I'm going downstairs. I'm going to the conservatory.
Not quite yet, but yes, you're on
next
your way.
Next turn.
Yep.
I will be
on
there.
Your
way.
Turn.
Go.
Okay, I have to roll to get out of the junk room, so.
Wait, can this still be my turn real quick?
What do you need to do? Equip the mask. Yeah.
I want to equip the mask.
You lose 2 knowledge.
No, I
gain
it.
Oh, no,
I can gain it.
Okay.
So she has, but does she have to roll to get it on?
Yes.
Yeah.
That's real
I should make
right
a
there.
Sanity roll. I want 4.
Your sanity is full. What do you have to roll?
4 or more.
Go.
Boom.
She makes it.
You
she
put
equips
on mask.
The mask.
So I gain 2
Does that help you in any way?
He gains 2 knowledge, loses 2
I
sanity.
Mean, it got Jim Carrey the girl, so.
It's true.
But he was also
what?
Cuban Pete.
The mask.
The king of the movie.
Anyway.
Moving on.
I have limited quiver
movie
of
knowledge.
Jim Carrey movies. Sorry.
Okay, so what's the
Henry.
Roll I have to
Henry
make
anymore.
To get out of the junk room?
You just roll a 3 plus.
3 plus.
Strength. Sorry, might.
The might. Okay, thank you. That's what I was wondering. I took a might damage. That's... Okay.
You made it.
I made it.
Yay!
Cool. I'm going to use my 3 moves to get to the conservatory. And then AJ and I have to swap shit.
We have to do what?
You have to swap.
Both of them?
One randomly.
I apologize!
I mean, it doesn't really matter.
It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter, because neither of us are the traitor.
That you know of.
Yeah, but you have to come up here eventually.
Nah, I'm making herbs.
I am not the traitor.
But you've been infected.
But you've been
you
infected.
Are the traitor.
And it's against the rules to say you're not the traitor. So.
But you are the traitor. We already know this.
What?
I know. That's.
Just go.
Just go, David.
Anyway, no, it's still my turn.
Oh, never mind. It's your turn. Knowledge check.
I'm doing a knowledge check. My knowledge
is 4. I did not give my spores to that woman.
I have to. What? It's a 4 or more?
That was a good joke.
Nice. Goddamn.
Culturally aware.
I fucked up too.
Relevant.
Beginning of his turn or end of his turn?
Beginning of his turn.
So, the first thing we need to do
is we move, progress the track. I guess I'll do your turn for you.
Ah, that's how many damage.
Hey, it just went to 3 now.
I'm the damage man.
On what?
It starts at 1, goes to 2.
Oh, it starts at 1?
Yes.
And it's not exponential. It's incremental, right?
I would think that the first increment would be from 0 to 1.
That is a 0. It said put it at 1.
Okay, fair.
So.
Then why is 0 there?
There's probably
For other.
Yeah, I answered my own question. I'm sorry.
No, you're good. Okay, so he's rolling 2.
Rolling
two. Against
our
all
might.
Of us.
Our might. All of our might, yeah.
But we all do a might roll, or is it our might base?
Might.
I don't know about you guys, but I'm rolling for speed.
It doesn't have matter. Nothing. It's irrelevant.
Okay, can I still
move? Okay, it's not hitting us, so everyone's good.
Yes, you can still move and stuff.
I'm confused. Can I move through the laboratory?
Can, but there's he's there, door. Too.
Yeah, well, I mean, we're...
So if I were to just be... If I were to just... Do this.
Yeah, you can do that.
Of course, he's gonna not help me in any way, shape, or form.
I've been waiting to do that for like 15 minutes.
Yeah.
Yes. Oh no, there's a disease. The cure could be in the lab. We're straight through the lab.
Well, you have the disease.
Damn it, David does room game.
Also, it's in the order.
I never
want to
play a game with David ever again.
What?
He's not a team player.
What a dick.
Just think of how boring this game would have been without me. And
you're the one that's making the game last longer by not actually doing anything.
That took us like an hour and a half to be the first game.
I didn't read the event.
Do you remember how I warned everyone saying, okay, now you have
an
example of how I ruin games. Okay, do you see?
Let's go.
Let him
image in the mirror is my event. There's an old mirror in this room. Your frightened reflection moves on its own. That's not a mirror, then. It's a display. You realize it is you from another time. Your reflection writes on the mirror, "This will help." Then it hands you an item through the mirror. Draw an item card. I also am going to request...
I hope it's not a dirty syringe.
I'm going to request an item that's from the future that's cheap but is not right now, so I can sell it. Make some extra cash. I've just gained an item, which is an idol. Perhaps it's chosen you for some greater purpose, like human sacrifice. I choose to ignore it. Once per turn, you can rub the idol before making any trait, combat, or event roll to add 2 dice to the roll, to a maximum of 8 dice. Each time you do, lose 1 sanity. Not going to be doing any rubbing, so that's irrelevant. So sorry I've wasted your time.
I'm really hoping you don't do any rubbing. This is a house of learning to die.
This is a house of fucking aliens.
If this idol gained me speed, I'd be rubbing every turn. Because I would sacrifice all of my sanity.
To rub it at.
To go
rub
fast.
It out. Every
see,
turn.
It's much. Yeah. Anyway.
Super fast.
Alright, I gotta go.
Bye.
Okay, so Peter's dying.
Coming yet.
You're not leaving yet?
No.
Okay.
So it's
I'm
me.
Kidding.
It's your turn.
So I just do this
it's
thing.
An
right?
Awkward conversation.
What do I do?
Well, if you do decide to leave, you'll be able to
you
catch
can go
up
to the
conversation results
server
of the game.
To get intelligence, or you can come up to research
on
See, actually, David has successfully killed the game for me because he has the one, which is the one that gets transferred, which makes it to where other people become traitors. So,
do you see how my one talent is ruining fun?
He has successfully made it to where I cannot win.
Good.
Except by killing you.
Good.
So we win.
Yeah, you guys win.
I'm glad that now I have a 2.5-hour video to explain. Whenever people are like, what do you mean you're not fun when you play games? Here you go, folks. There you go, rather.
Well,
the game's over. I won because I'm the fastest. And I won at the beginning.
Same game, different hand. He always win.
Every time.
Every time.
What's the name of this game?
I win.
Wait.
Well, technically,
we are done, right?
Yeah. No, we're actually done.
Because
you're not going to play.
Yeah.
Wow. You have made it so it is impossible for the heroes are going to win.
So this is a really detailed example of how I ruined
the game. Yeah,
yes.
No, you've actually ruined the game.
Sorry. Sorry about that.
You're not sorry, though.
No, I am.
Sorry, not sorry?
I just,
Sorry, not sorry. I say that all the time.
The way to win the game is always not to play.
And you picked a random one.
Yeah.
And it just happened to be that you lost
yeah.
that one, specifically.
Yeah. I was not the traitor.
God damn it, Dave.
Okay.
Get out of his house.
So I'd like to say that this was a very,
I mean, this. I cannot forget this.
I can't say, shit show.
It wasn't memorable.
Can't say it was a good game.
How many warnings did I
have? It wasn't bad.
It was an interesting game. I don't think we actually got anything done.
Oh, there they are.
I ate them.
It is 2 a.m.
Earlier today, Caitlin asked me to explain how I ruin games, and
Karen,
we provided a function because now.
What other cards?
She knows exactly.
Oh, they must have ended up.
You see, I'm totally okay with that. That made the game interesting for me. Because there was a point in this game I was like, this is fucking stupid. Why are we just walking around?
The trader part?
Why aren't we driving?
Oh my gosh.
No, it's like, okay, we're going to explore all these things. These things keep happening. Fucking big ass birds that make no fucking sense.
You don't make sense.
So really, your only issue is the bird.
Yes, really.
Okay.
This bird. Okay, I'm ending the stream. I would like to just finish by saying I was not the traitor. Thank you for watching. You can find this whole game on youtube.com/drywallmusic. If that's too hard for you, you can just follow me on Twitter because I'll probably be there somewhere. All the links are somewhere.
All the links are somewhere. You gotta find them.
Well, no, okay, if you're...
It's like a treasure hunt.
You gotta go through an abandoned house.
You ruin it.
Honestly, it takes 2 seconds. You know how social media works, hopefully, if you're watching a Periscope.
We love you.
Got it.
Hitler 2 is leaving.
Soon, yeah.
Robo Hitler, Mecha okay. Hitler 2.0.
My favorite thing is that every single time she says she's leaving, immediately after she says,
there you go.
Soon. She's like, oh, I gotta go.
Choose.
Soon.
Tip.
Oh, are we
signing
off?
Can we light
these?
I was not the traitor. There we go.
Take your
cubes with you.
You love me.
Okay. Goddamn. I was still not a traitor.
Goddamn. Goddamn.
Here's
which one?
The rest of the...
Just a Ziploc bag.
Player cards.
For what?
Do you need to stop your recording?
Oh, to steal your cookies?
Unless...
I was gonna take one cookie, you
guys can rest.
Well,
she's...
We don't care.
So are we... Are you kicking me out now? Am I done?
No, you can stay. We're just done playing.
Okay, because I was gonna say, I might as well use all the battery for these devices.
Okay. So what are we gonna discuss?
How is it
like that? Literally anything.
Alright, can we discuss how cool it would be if Bill Clinton was going to be the first man?
The first man?
Yeah, think about it.
Okay, I thought you were talking about, Adam.
No, I mean the first man, as in, he's going to be the husband of the president of the United States. Like, don't get me wrong, I don't want Hillary to win by any stretch of the imagination.
No, I was reading this thing that if Hillary, right now, with her polls, that she would win over Bernie Sanders, and if that does happen, that... Donald Trump's gonna beat her, but if Bernie Sanders
Trump's
beats
not win
her,
the Republican nomination.
Well, whatever the Republican nomination.
Donald
beats,
Trump will never be president of the United States.
He better fucking
not. He's not going to be president of the United States. Just trust me, it's not going to happen.
Good.
It is not, and if it did happen,
he would be
impeached.
If he won, it would be rich.
He would be impeached within seconds. Seriously. Look at Donald Trump. Look at how he reacts to situations. He's a wonderful businessman. He cannot be president of the United States. He just will. You cannot be president of the United States and not play by the rules. That just doesn't work. So, anyway, okay, well, I guess I'll at least end tabletop 4.
No, you ended that a while ago. Good job.
No, I ended the stream.
No, he ended the Periscope.
You don't understand, Terry. I'm a media legend.
So if it's tabletop,
everywhere I go, media follows.
So if we've done tabletop 4, should we do an epilogue of tabletop 4?
No, we're saying
we
want to
talk about
signing off.
Talk about what happened. Talk about our flaws.
Does anyone have a copy of Candyland anywhere?
Probably
no, I'm not playing any game ever with you ever again. Ever.
I will. I will play Candyland with
shit. Because that was supposed to be the premise of this video series we're starting now.
Nope.
Okay. Okay.
But for real though, I'm gonna.
Thank you, Greg.
Thanks, guys.
All right, so tabletop 4. Thanks for
one.
Thanks for watching. You've been schooled, and I was not the traitor.